which means one main thing: infidelity. Now, that's not for the illustrious men at the man cave. That's for y'all trifling ass niggas. But I'm going to pass the baton of accountability on the women since y'all struggle with that part. I'm going to blame y'all women. Yeah. Look yourself in the mirror. You, bitch, with the tank top on.
I'm done.
It's your fault. See, y'all see the weather change and act the fool like Ludacris and them. You wear your sundresses and your maxi dresses showing all the bootylicious curves. The two pieces showing the belly button, navel, and that's what the summer brings, making men disbehave and some other things. You see, if I'm going to be strictly honest with you, it leads to one or two things. Booties be bouncing, niggas be pouncing, we start having sex in unfurnished housing. Gas prices damn near $2 got me putting in by the ounce. And I just looked at my mom's old account and it's less than $1,000.
Wow.
You see, please, I refrain. Do not invite me to your summer shindigs, your Negro rigmaroles, for me to make up the numbers because you want me to chip in on your little table. I am more than comfortable in general population. You see, I'm aware that it's going to be a lituation, but you are not going to be there to help me with my financial situation. So please, if you need somebody to chip in on the lesser side of things, like the soft drinks, which include orange sodas, cream sodas, cranberry pineapple, and what have you, I am your guy. Hit me on the +44. Or I'll kindly sit at home and act a fool on my daddy's Wi-Fi. Now, on a more impressive matters, Lord, as we are here at the man cave, you're going to POS pop our shit without fear of these five crucial things: retribution, reparations, retaliation, contraception, and most importantly, number five, reconciliation. Because, brother,
we ain't trying to reconcile with y'all.
No,
bitches.
No, no. We ain't. Now let us bow our heads and say a thankful thug's prayer. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Oh, that was a pastor offering. That was a great sermon.
I was really moved by what you said.
Now we can get into today's proceedings. Where do we start? The docket is quite full, but we're going to start with that perpetrator over there.
Oh, here we go.
Wow.
First of all, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Thank you,
happy birthday. Second of all, you know, first episode of the podcast, you know, I had a list.
Back in the day, innit?
Back in the day. Episode one. Reasons why Gina
was single.
Mm-hmm. And one of those reasons was that you got too many male friends.
Just too many bros.
And so, over the, what was it? Yesterday?
It was yesterday.
I was like, obviously, she's reposting all the birthday shouts, isn't it? Thank you, bro. I'm like, how many bros do you have?
He literally goes, you honestly have gone down the history. He goes, you must be the one. What do you say?
Wait, I'm going to read it. Let me read it.
Yeah.
Dog, can you say that?
I just thought, okay.
How many bros
you got?
I said, how many bros? I said, it's enough. Obviously, it's not the reason why you're single, but
it's a contributing factor.
Contributing factor.
Oh, man. I know.
You know what? The Icklist was hilarious.
Oh, what, my Icklist?
Yeah,
I posted something today, though, which someone sent me because of the podcast and was like, that this reminded me of you. And it was like, your Icklist is basically your like defense mechanism of like they were explaining why you do it, basically. And for me, it made sense. And I was like, I'm literally being extra for no reason because I'm scared.
So I said, you might hold the record for having the most bros of all time. I said, no, how many bros do you have? Like,
I don't have that many.
No, you have a lot of like close male friends.
Mm-hmm.
And even when I think you can have no more, you bring up a new one. Oh yeah, that means
Kenny's a new boy now. Yeah, like, new friends.
I'm
there.
The bros them.
Mm-mm. So what the girls is what? the Gloria Repulse, the Christabel, Doreen, Dorothy, maybe a couple others, and the rest is just mad them.
Hear me out. Let me land you.
Hold on. After she sent the voice note, I said, I'm glad somebody has noticed, because I think she said that someone else said
someone else. No, but...
And I said, basically, stop cultivating
this behavior.
Close friendship slash bonds with men.
All right, cool. We can get into that, right?
That's interesting.
We can get into... I think this is a perfect topic for this podcast.
Yeah, go on.
Right now. So, Gina, growing up, tomboy, mandem. It's always been natural for me to form relationships with men over women, because... I didn't have things in common with women, but like when people were, you know, about hair, makeup and the kind of more girly side of life, that wasn't me.
Mm.
Do you get what I mean?
Yeah.
I had two older brothers. My sister was a 12 year age gap. So again, and even when my sister was born, it's not like we were close. So I had someone to like play with and do makeup with and whatnot. So a lot of the time I was around males when it comes to my cousins and stuff. Yeah, my things are evenly split. But when I was younger, the cousins I used to be really close to were boys, my two male cousins. So I used to sleep at their house and spend a lot of time with them. So I've always had a heavy male presence in my life, naturally. So let's take away friends. This is just based on like my upbringing. So naturally, it's easier for me to form a relationship with a man than it is a woman, generally speaking. So that's just how I am. And it happens. It's not because I don't, and I do say sometimes that I don't really like girls, but we said this on the woman case, so to speak, yeah. And I was saying how, like, I find relationships with men sometimes a lot more straightforward. I don't have to compete with a man, or we're not competing. He's not trying to have one over me because he thinks I'm prettier than him, or he doesn't have, like, could you get what I mean? Generally speaking, I kind of know what our friendship is. If it's platonic, it's platonic. If you want to fuck me, I know you want to fuck me. But it's not really going to be...
Damn, girl, you got a party mouth.
You know this. I've been having a party mouth. But I mean, like, it's not... There's just less... I find relationships with men a bit more straightforward than with girls and women, right?
So wait, slow down. Because... So you think that there's this little underlying competition in girl groups?
Covering your whole
not even girl groups, because in my circle of friends, in my circle of, like, my friendship groups, not with them. And I have my core... female friends, you lot know this, do you know what I mean? Like, so it's not like when you see me out, I'm always with guys. You're going to see me with girls.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? I just have one-on-one relationships with men.
Yeah.
But as a collective, I have my circle of girls, more than one circle of girls. Do you get what I mean?
Yeah.
But I just find women quite sneaky at times, and especially like going through like the teenage era where you're finding yourself and everyone has issues and insecurities. And with me, I was very insecure, but you would never really know that because of how I portrayed myself in it. So it was always... So you wouldn't think I was insecure.
Yeah.
But I was. And then having girls around me do snaky things like befriend me because of my ex-boyfriend at the time, or like act like they're my friends, but then we'll talk behind my back and say stuff like, she's not even pretty, why does she have a man? All, like, do you know what I mean? Like, so there's all of that stuff.
Yeah.
Like... just always, not put me off, but I just always was on edge when it came to meeting new women and like friendship groups and stuff. So that's why these people are going to be like, I ain't buying this shit.
No, I'm buying it, but no, it is. I'm here for the funnies and you're taking this to
very deep, serious. Sorry. No, do you know why I had to do that? I had to do that because I had to take it deep and serious in this, because obviously if Future Bae is listening to this episode, he can't be here listening to me catch corn and think it's all banter and jokes. So we're going to get into the funny. But I'm giving context.
Don't talk
so
to this.
Do you know what I mean? Because you are going to rip this up and put it
clip. This is never going to be a clip. It's not going to be a clip. But let's count, though, innit? Let's count.
All right, cool.
With the bros, innit? Start with myself. We go Lanre. We go Big Boat. We'll go...
my friend Alan.
Alan, yep. Shifty, Fola. Yes, what are you...
Okay.
Well, that's what about six, seven so far? Sid.
Seven.
Yeah. Brent.
Eight.
Eugene. Yeah. I know about Eugene.
Yeah, stealing a nigga cake. I know about that picture. He puts up every year, bro.
Me and Eugene had a little conversation in Ghana. You talking about y'all little relationship.
Hold on a minute. Eugene's family, though.
As in your actual family.
As in like...
as in the bros them, yes. That's another name.
Yeah, but that's not fair because we like literally grew up together. Like our fam.
So?
Alright, cool.
There's Sam.
That's Uncle Sam, though. Again, yeah.
Don't matter about him being an uncle.
Uncle Sam?
No, but hear me out.
He's not your uncle.
No, but do you know what? Do you know why I'm saying this, yeah? Again, Sam is like, the reason why that's unfair, yeah,
to his family.
Is because he literally, if my mum had another son who wasn't her birth son,
yeah,
it's him. Like, from a... All right, fine.
That's not a reason to dismiss him.
Okay, right. No, I get it. I'm just, to be honest.
Who's your mentor? Is it Mike Brown? What's his name?
Mike Lau.
No, Marv. My
Marv. Yeah, Marv Brown.
Yeah,
that's another
that's
one.
That's bro.
What about the guy you trained with? I think he might be Brent's boy with the dreads.
Oh, Richards.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Rich.
Richard again.
I forgot Richard. I was like thinking, yeah, Rich.
And then all the guys I saw the other day that I posted on your thing.
My friend Alan.
That's about three guys that I said bro to.
You know, let's actually be fair, you know.
So now we're approaching 20.
God. I didn't realize he was at David's party.
Who's David? Oh, yeah. But again, see, this is 19. Hear me out, yeah. Again.
Fuck it, Jason as well, 20.
Hear me out, Jason, yeah. So we see, again, David, yeah. Again, they're my big brothers. Like, literally, they've known me since I was a kid.
No, I know the context.
Do you get what I mean? They've literally known me since I was a teen, like a kid, because of my older brothers. And obviously...
Yeah, but they're still bros then.
No, yeah, they are. No, literally.
So why are you trying to dismiss them? I'm not.
Okay, I got one. All right, cool. Think right now. How many of these boys became your bedrooms? But it originated from trying to draw you.
Everybody you said?
Or anyone you can think
okay,
of.
Okay, out of anyone you said, not one person. Okay. None of the people you've mentioned was a, let me move to you, and then we became friends, and then they became bro. Yeah. Not one of them.
Oh, sorry, Pat.
Again, yeah, you yeah, Pat is bro. That's, I mean, I stayed with him in Dubai. That's what, and
21 now?
That rattled everybody.
Is that the henchman?
No, that's Josh. Contact with.
Josh is what? 22. Oh, and even Mr. Is it OTT? Where? What's his name?
Oh, Ollie.
Ollie. Rose them as well. That's 22 or 23.
Jordan. Keep going.
This
on.
List is long, you know.
Extensive. But you know what's so mad about listening to this?
Yeah.
Gina's the opposite to some women that I know that have no
male friends.
No male. Like, I remember speaking to her and they were like,
no. I am.
So okay. They don't have no male friends. I was like, what do you mean? I was like, so you've got none, not one.
Yeah.
Actually, I'll tell you who it was after.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, because they said it and I was like, what?
Yeah.
So, you're going to be my first male friend. I said,
I've got about 40 names, you know.
I'm not going to lie. It's peak.
She said, I've been thinking.
I've been thinking, you know what? You're right. I'm named bare people.
Yeah. And that's probably not even.
You're probably half.
And then I even mentioned all the Marvin and the Chizzo and them man as well. Like, I mean, on top.
Yeah, but I wouldn't.
You know, they ain't the bros, them.
See, this is the thing.
But they're still cool with you. Like,
yeah, but it's not.
Right, cool. I'll remove them.
I think that's not fair.
I'll remove them. Mm.
But technically, they contribute to the people that in any world, undateables now. Because you've built up a rapport. So they can't even be considered a candidate.
All right, cool.
So it's exactly. Yeah, association friends is.
You know
what
it is?
Well.
Hear me out. Wow. She's a collector.
She's a collector for real.
But I hear what you're saying, yeah?
Yeah. Also, this is bad. There's nothing wrong with
No. Do you know why?
Yeah.
Because my male friend. No, do you know why? The other day, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Someone I know had a little back and forth.
Yeah.
And he said to me, oh, I think I snapped.
Oh, sorry. Moof.
I snapped. 27?
Oh, we're 42.
You know, let me drink my tea.
Moof as well.
God damn it.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Sorry, go on, carry on. Why are you sticking your tongue all the way in there?
Basically,
Yeah.
It's just about who I found common ground with. I don't know, innit? Gosh.
You should have been born a boy.
No, but remember, I told you my mum said this,
yeah.
When I was born, she literally was like, and seeing how I was and my characteristics, she literally said, I should have had a son because who are you?
Yeah.
And it's only in the last couple of years where I've embraced my girly side.
Yeah.
This is very recent.
Do you remember the conversation about Baddie?
When Yusuff said I could never be a baddie and I'm not a baddie and it was a big thing and everyone was like
that's where the marketing
started
because I was like Gina's has changed
I want to make a statement.
More dresses?
Gina has become a baddie.
Okay, fair enough.
Yeah.
You become a baddie.
Marketing has leveled up consistently, season by season, not even Yeah, but season by season. Yeah.
You know why I like Jason? Because me and Jason stay talking about marketing, boy. He will literally be like, shout out to the marketing team, Gina. I see what you're doing there.
Yeah, because your first... Your first
marketing... I'm talking about the place of the shorts.
That was so...
wait. What JPEG was this one? Where was I?
Her first ever Train to Slay pick, was atrocious, bro. It was...
Is that when you started the pod?
No, it was her wearing like knee high boots.
Yes.
Knee high boots with like hot pants, yeah. She had the resistance band wrapped around, what was it? Wrapped around the heels. And she was bent over and looking back like Nikki or Kim or something, fam. It was the first
knee high boots like for the club. And you're wearing
it was the first Train to Slay.
No, so basically, it was called, the class was called Train to Twerk. So it was
is that when you did it with
Bam Boogie?
Me and Marv had a field day with
No, I know, because you said, I remember you said it got sent to you. I remember you said the pic got put in your group chat. I was so upset.
God damn it.
You posted it.
He's dumbfounded. Do you understand?
Hey, YouTube was like, what the fuck is this?
She actually posted it. It wasn't like, oh, yo, you swear figure this. I might post it. No, she posted it.
Wait, let me find the picture.
You know what's mad? Please. I can imagine Yusuff looking at his phone like, what is going on?
I think I messaged you.
Who okayed this? Who gave you the thumbs up?
No, man. I need to find it. But all I remember is we even spoke about it in the pod, but Yusuff, like, he mocked.
That picture was too funny, bro. Because it's like when, you know, when these photographers get a hold of the girls and they
put them in the Cheerios.
Yeah. They could do mad things. Like, man's in a bathtub with bare ketchup bottles. Like, just random shit like that. Like, is any photographer. Oh, man.
You see them photographers, they are criminals, you know?
Yeah. The concepts and some of the concepts, they're just so left. Like, why are you...
I need you to put some hands, your hand in some jam.
Yeah, just look back at me with the jam, like smell for the jam on the table. Like, it's weird. All right. Speaking of you and your friends, one of your friends was getting cooked like hot grease.
Oi.
Deep fried.
With hot grease.
Like, smut report.
No. Can I say something? Yeah, listen.
Doreen.
I've not laughed so hard. I think we should go through the thread. Because some of the quote tweets had me in tears.
All right, so context.
And you know what's mad? I tried to save her. I said, delete this.
Yeah, also.
But she was like, it's too late.
King Kessie. Where's King Kessie, man?
Her thing is in...
I can find it.
It's Miss Kess.
I beg someone bring up them tweets, bro.
No, I'll find it.
Right, so it's
probably seen in my mentions, people.
It's related to, so basically, is everyone here watching Love Island?
I've only watched the first episode, you know. I've been out the last 2 days. So.
Missing it right now. Yeah. I heard Dami's about to turn up, but that's another story.
And Afia's about to turn it.
Oh, yes, Afia.
Afia.
Our guardians and stuff.
I'm not gonna lie to you. She might be a quick turnaround.
You think?
Do you know when women say, I'm coming to take all your mans? They always.
Yeah,
they always do it.
That's a script, though.
Always get.
It's probably a teleprompt to say this.
No, but they say that, but then they always get a swift turnaround. Like,
What's
that mean where, you know, someone walks in, takes off the jacket, and they walk back out?
Oh, yeah,
that's how quick it is.
It's a lie. And I'm coming to step on toes. It's like a lie, man. Just be yourself.
Why do you find the tweet? What's your thoughts on David 27 hooking up with Gemma 19?
You know what? Yeah, I've seen loads of outrageous tweets.
Now, you know what's
weird about it?
Yeah.
It's almost like the change of the times.
Yeah.
Because those people changed it. Because I was like, hold on. People's parents.
Yeah.
They check the ages.
The age gap.
The age gap. They'll be looking at them like, hold on.
Yeah, the age gap might be big, but when did they meet though?
When did they meet? But I think it's weird in the sense of, in this circumstance, there's nothing they can do.
Mm.
Nothing they can do. My biggest thing is when it's like, someone is big 30 plus.
Yeah.
And they go into places where you know the teeny boppers are at.
Yeah,
teeny boppers.
And you're almost taking advantage of the fact of your age. You know
yeah.
Okay. So the question is: this is 19 and 27. Yeah.
Mm.
At what ages? What thresholds does 8-year gap become acceptable?
You know what? It's only acceptable as it gets older.
So
I think from 25.
25 and
30. No, it depends on how old the man is as well.
He said 8-year gap. So I'm saying if you're 25 and you're dating a 33-year-old.
Yeah, but the 8-year, eight, year gap could be anywhere, but what age should a woman be for it to even be a thing?
No, that's yeah, that's what I said. Saying. I know.
Well, she's over 25.
25 I think is still too... I think 27.
And 35.
Wait, so you're
but
saying...
You know,
wait,
a woman who's 27.
No, but that means you're saying you don't think a girl who's 23 can date a man who's 8 years old, 7 years old, 8 years old.
I don't. Why are you there?
Okay.
Okay. No, level.
Wait, did I stutter?
She
a 23-year-old
that.
With a 31-year-old.
They are doing it. They are doing it. The hypergamy joints, they're doing it.
They've been doing it. You know what's so weird?
No, but they have been. That's I don't think that's even uncommon.
That's
a 30-year-old with a 27-year-old.
That's not uncommon.
A what?
It's not uncommon.
A 30-year-old with a 27-year-old.
23-year-old.
It's not uncommon.
It's not uncommon.
23 and 31. Yeah.
I'm not gonna
I don't think that's uncommon in this day and age.
It's not uncommon, but you know, I think
it's disgusting.
I think in the circumstances of like, what was I going to say? When women turn, some women turn 27,
yeah,
instead of like older guys, and they're going for not they're going for 40-year-olds plus. you hear it and you're like, okay,
let's call it.
And you're like, okay, now I need someone mature who's got his life together. Mm-hmm. He knows his priorities.
A dental plan. Yeah.
This is why. Like my aunts, everyone stays saying to me, Gina, you need to increase your age bracket of the men that you're looking for, right?
Mm.
Don't date your age. But I'm not going to lie. I'm not celebrating my guy's 40th at this age. I know it's not that big of a deal, but
damn.
How high can you go?
No, that's but...
I'm saying me and Jay's creeping up.
No, you are.
Gina, you ain't come?
No, but do you get what I'm trying to say?
Yeah,
though?
Yeah,
like,
I know.
You're creeping up there, but you're not there.
I think it because there was a thing about like basically how people mature and the age, and I think for some of women's wants and needs,
mm-hmm.
as in an older guy. Because example, you see some of the things when women say they want to settle down, and the guys to be in be right, basically set right, money sorted, blah blah blah. It's generally older guys that have that because they've gone through the development stage of whatever.
More years in the workplace and all of that stuff.
Yeah, they've gone through the development stage.
I think life in general. Like,
yeah, they've gone through more life. So they're a bit more, like, I suppose, maybe appreciative. They kind of...
Did you find tweets, by the way?
Yeah, I did. And also, let's say, for example, that...
You've been yamming that cake, bro.
Sorry, it's my dinner, innit?
It's your dinner?
Done.
That's what you're having today is a cake?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I don't know. You see the nap I had,
yeah?
You're not even lucky I'm here, bro.
Jewel sleep, yeah?
Listen, it was so wild. I could have slept until tomorrow.
Nice.
To be honest, yesterday was wild.
I was fighting sleep, to be fair.
I had one of those.
No, I was so tired. Like, I needed to nap, and then the nap just... Woo.
Came here earlier as well, didn't
you? Yeah. Yeah, the morning. Damn. Read all his tweet, then.
Oh, fine. But Jason, what I wanted to say to what you were saying was... What I wanted to say...
Nigga, you were guest.
Anyway, is... even if it's not even on a financial thing, let's say for example, like you at in your 20s compared to you now in terms of like dating, being outside, club holidays, all of that stuff. Yeah. You not everyone goes through it, but the majority of men go through that period. So like if you want, let's say you're looking for, you want to settle, you want to get married.
Stability,
right? Mm. Some people are just like, I'm still getting my toes wet. Do you know what I mean? And whether you might find an older guy who, that's why my aunt's like, I'm not going for 40 year old, but she's like, but at 40, he's seasoned in being outside. He's had 20 years of chasing girls and like, you know what I mean? Mm. He's tired.
Yeah.
Or he should be tired.
Yeah.
So you're more likely going to find someone who's willing to be calm and chill and settle down and be willing to like get married within a year or all of that stuff because, you know, they've experienced so many women, they know when, do you know what I mean?
Yeah. But you know, my thing with that big age gap dating is that I told all the girls that I know that are looking for, I want an older guy. I said, be very careful because when you start aging, and you've got this 8-10 year gap and these men grow old, you start watching women become a housemaid. I've seen too many aunties, it's like, I'm 55, he's 65. He's immobile now. So you're looking after him, waiting hand and foot, and it's like you're gonna outgrow your husband. Like, so I'm always like, find your age, find that 2 years under to 3 years
me
above.
No, but hear me out though. The thing is, let's talk about you men, when it comes to like, let's be honest, some people would say that like, well, according to your king, I'm in the danger zone. Yeah.
Oh,
God,
who's king? His soul.
Huh? Who's king? King? Oh, he's king.
Everybody.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah. Just for clarification, I don't have a king. She's talking about Kevin Samuels. And Sid is the person she's referring to.
So it's like, when I talk to my friends, like, who are like single and looking for girls, I'm going to be honest, they're not checking for girls my age.
Do you believe that you're in the danger zone?
No, because I don't look my age. And to be honest with you, what's really interesting though, yeah, is I get moved to by younger guys all the time. Mm. Like, and their energy, I'm always impressed because their level of vim, mind blowing. Like, literally, even like,
because they're fresh in the field.
And also because, you know why it's the level of vim? Because if they see you as a grown woman,
yeah.
You know, like, you see a grown woman, like, yeah. Cool. I can't even do that funny shit.
And also, they're fresh in the
field. But obviously, I don't look my age though. So it's never a.
What age do you think you look?
You look old. I'd say I look about.
You think you can hang with a 27 year old?
I was going to literally say like 27, 28.
Bluffing.
Okay.
Wow.
I'm joking.
Only because, I know I don't look my age. I don't look 33. Two, I continuously get approached by younger boys. So it must be. And whenever they approach me, I can tell they're young, innit? And my I always do this where I'm like, you're a baby. And they get offended because I'm always on that small boy thing, right?
I got it, man. I got
and
it.
And I'm always literally like, you're a baby. How old are you? And then they say age. And then I'm like, how old do you think I am? And they're like, and it's always between 25 to 28. And I'm like, I said, you should call me auntie. And they're like, what do you mean you should call me auntie? And I'm like, I'm 33. Swear down. Yeah, I'm 33. So I know, but I don't look my age. Mm. Regardless, I don't look 33 in it, so whatever. But the vim that they come with, even when I say my age, it's like, you think they care? They're like, so? Like, you need to give us young boys a chance. Clearly, the guys your age aren't doing it, which is why you're single. I'm just thinking, well, damn.
You might have a point. What's the youngest you could do, though?
Nah.
Why not?
No, but don't. This is what I'm saying. If you can find a gem in the plus 28 crowd, you know.
Do you know what's crazy? Yeah?
No, you can't.
No.
She's shitting on y'all niggas.
No, hear me out. Not loose. Do you know why? No. So two of my close friends are with guys who one turned 30 this year.
Yeah.
She's 34 in December.
Yeah.
Right? Cute. She's married to him.
Yeah.
They got kids.
Lupa Linda.
Sorry. Yeah, that's 30 though. You're talking about 28.
No, 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 no. He turned 30 this year. They've been married for 2 years. So when she met him, he wasn't 30.
He's an anomaly.
Right. My other friend is with her partner. Mm. And again, he just turned 29. Mm. And she's again 34 in December. So there's a five year age between them.
But that's only a 2-person sample size.
No, sexy, I know, but sexy. What I'm saying is, and when I speak to them, they're just like, you know what, yeah. Like, if you meet a guy who ticks your boxes, like, do you know what? I get it. It's like, sometimes you can't allow factors such as age, height. I know I'm highest. I know. Hold on. Hear me out. I said this.
No, I'm going to say age. You said you can't let factors such as age, but you're like, the biggest ages here.
I know. That's what I'm saying. Sometimes.
Yeah.
I know, but it's probably one of my...
Yeah.
My... No, so it's not. No.
If you meet someone that's 29, like, oh, so we saying, you're like
29. If he was 30, I'd give it a blind.
Tell me what the actual problem is, because you just need one.
Okay.
I know the stigma about the young is not mature, and but there's one that could be like your two.
To be honest, that's a theme though. You just need one.
Just need one.
Okay. My thing is with a younger guy. Yeah. All right. It's different things, and I think it depends on where you are mentally. Because for me. My thing is, I'm at that age where I want to settle. I want to be out the game. I'm ready to be out the game tomorrow. Yesterday, even, yeah?
Mm.
It's the ghetto.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't want to put pressure on you if that's not where you're at.
Oh, you got to marry me tomorrow?
The fuck, yeah. Like, not tomorrow, but do you understand what I mean? For me, not sooner rather than later, but like, I want to settle. I'm ready to settle. Do you know what I mean? So, if you're 29 or 28, and obviously, your thing is you're still getting your career together, you're still finding yourself, you're still whatever. That's brilliant. And I don't want to be the person to make you feel some type of way because your journey isn't, like, you're not where I need you to be yet. And I don't want you to get there because of me, like, in your own time.
But people inspire people without realizing it. When people get into relationships, the partner you have really should inspire you in one way or the other.
Mm.
So, you like, maybe you don't want the pressure, but, or someone might meet you and be like, you know what? she's got together. I need to, and they're not even putting it on you, but they just feel like you're inspiring them.
Yeah.
And that could be hand in hand. It's not really a bad thing. It's just how, unless it comes up in an argument, you know, people have their like, oh, I'm only doing this because of you, then that's the problem. But yeah. If not, could inspire them.
No, I hear you. I think,
fuck them kids.
them little coming, niggas.
Me coming to Yusuff and be like, hi, Yusuff, my boyfriend. He'll be like, how old is he? 28. He's going to be like, 28?
You're a whippersnapper.
And it literally is going to, do you know what I mean? But I do, I don't, do you know what? Yeah, it's honestly, it's maturity in it. It's where you're at in life. If yeah. you...
to be fair, sorry, Lukeman's missus is older than him.
Is it?
Yeah. I might be wrong. I think about 3 or 4 years.
Yeah. See? So if, do you know what? If I meet someone who's on job in every sense of the word, like you're just, you've got yourself together, you know what you're doing, and we're on the same wavelength, then I'm open to it. I do admit that, like, the moment I hit a certain age, I
can you even down. Get past that
I
question?
Know. Yeah. Do you know what? Let me be honest with you. If I'm attracted to you, then I possibly could. And it's about your appearance. Because to be honest, a lot of the guys who approach me who are younger than me, they're small.
Stature and height.
Yeah, they're things. Just they're not petite, but like
scrawny petite. You can't call a man petite.
I know, yeah. I do say that.
Like you got a little curve. In like, a little 5'5". A little brown five. Hey, respect them, man.
Like he's just they're like petite-ish. Like
you're not a man yet.
Yeah.
You ain't got your man strength yet.
You ain't good to your man body.
And you're young as well, yeah. So it's just like it's not even like if you were older. And you were a bit petite. I can squint an eye and you know what I mean, look to the 90-degree angle. And be like,
no, yeah. In your head, we gonna train you.
Mm-hmm. So that's out of all your criteria, that's the most easily droppable one. Would you say?
What an age?
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like before we used to be kids. Mm. Now I'm open to like dating a guy with kids. Strange, not strange.
I've been hearing that.
Yeah, but like I'm just the age that I'm at, the age that. I guess I'm trying to date, et cetera, et cetera. I understand that most people are going to come with kids. Do you know what I mean? Mm. Kid. Let me not say kids. I can't do plural, please. Mm. But one, we may be able to have a conversation. But again, there's stipulations.
So. Let's see that the Doreen right. tweet, man. We need to...
Sorry.
Need to
sorry.
Get all serious on this kid.
Sorry.
The damn tweet.
This is our show, bitch. You just a guest. So Doreen tweeted, we need a Love Island for 30 to 40 year olds, not every day 23 and single for 1 year. It has 2,155 likes, 885 quote tweets, and 268.
Do you know how many quote tweets that is? That's almost 1,000 people commenting and saying, nigga, shut your
shut your bitch old ass up.
So
no, some of the responses I saw, I wish I just took screenshots of them.
No,
they were hilarious.
Many
someone said, oh, someone, okay, I heard the original tweet.
She was getting fried.
Let me go to quote tweets, because some of them...
Yeah, no, don't go to replies. Let's go to the quote tweets. That's what all the funnies are.
No one's watching Geriatric Island, please.
Yeah, that killed me. Yeah. Did you see the one where they said something about, oh, your guest, you know, like the like when they have like the My Jam, is it My Jam up? Where they get like the special person to come on. They said it's going to be Pastor Matthew Shimolowo.
What? No, people are creative.
No one wants to see 30-year-old Funke searching for her husband.
Oh my
God. Instead of you to sign up to the KICC Singles Conference with Pastor Yemesi.
Instead of you guys focusing on your first parents' evening, you're asking for Love Island.
Y'all try the sex position challenges in Casa Amor and will end up dislocating your hips.
Oh,
no.
Well, you have pension to be collecting. Goodness.
Reasonable.
Someone said, if you don't, you're dumb. Someone said, if you don't go and raise some children about Love Island.
This one, yeah, killed Masters Love.
Oh, yeah, the
Masters
yeah.
football.
The Masters
bro,
football.
That is too funny.
Where's the tweet? I can't find them.
The one that kills me is, I got a telegram. Did you see that one? I got a telegram.
Yeah, I saw that. I
cried.
Oh, no, that's a people are clever, man. I'm deep
today. Yeah, one thing that Twitter showed me, that people are very witty.
Yes.
Agbayaism is the new pandemic. It's called Come Dine With Me With Your Single Ass.
Yeah. Not Retirement Island. Go attend your church retreats then. If I wanted to watch pensioners, I would go to a care home.
Wow, someone said menopause Twitter. Always trying to get
no.
You don't do that. Nah, they suffer.
They called cod liver Twitter.
Cuddly Boy. Oh,
yeah, Twitter.
Which are Holland and Barrett going there.
We're there, though.
That's hilarious, man.
No, please, just go to his tweet and just read it for half an hour.
All right.
Have a laugh.
Ain't y'all tucking your grandkids in bed at your age? Instead of you to be watching Nollywood. No, you people are too old. Start a family. TD Jakes will be the host. It's called...
What's his place?
Granaries, yeah.
There's a place called Granaries in Croydon.
In Croydon.
No, this one killed me. If you don't turn on Homes Under the Hammer.
No, that's it. Flames. That's the one.
If you don't.
I can't deal.
This one's too specific.
Doreen saw so much traction in her life.
No, literally. I was waiting for her to be on the Shade Barber because I was like, this tweet is gold.
I was thinking I might need to delete my tweet to her because I was like, go and delete. And then people were liking the tweet.
Yeah.
And then one person, I woke up and there was bare notifications. Like, I didn't know what it's from. Crazy. And I was like, shoot, maybe I did something wrong.
TDJ. It's called Jeremy Clown.
Taking out your teeth before each challenge, allow it, man.
For frick's sake.
The thing is, yeah, I'm on the side of all these people. No one wants to see someone close to 40 on Love Island. I'm sorry. I don't want to see it.
They will pick the sexy 30.
I know, I ain't saying they're going to be sexy, but it's like, should you be here?
No, I think if it was not, I want to say, 25 to 30. Like just that.
I think 25 to 30 is cool. Not old.
I said close to 40. I said 25 to 30 is fine.
Yeah.
And David is 27. He's close 30 to 30.
Do you know what?
David.
Go on.
No, David.
Yeah.
So why did I retweet it on purpose?
Yeah.
Because everyone was like oring and ahhing.
Yeah.
And it was like, no way did that David is 5'5". I said, don't let the ladies see this. I said, like,
yeah. He ain't 5'5". He ain't 5'5". That's the camera angles making him look taller than him. Because he don't look 5'5 at all.
Literally.
He's got Tom Cruise camera angles.
What's
that
for?
That's the one. I was going to say there's an actor who stands on things, boxes and that.
Yeah. All right. What's our thoughts on Love Island anyway? What's our thoughts on the contestants? Dami, Ikenna.
Okay.
Amber, India.
Dami sounds like he's from Toronto, bruv. He's got a little Nigerian, Dublin, Canadian twang.
The Nigerian comes out a little bit.
Yeah. I'm not allowed to need some subtitles.
Oh, his accent's strong, isn't
it? Yeah, it's a bit like...
Yeah. Yeah. Ikenna is moving very some way-ish.
I'm not going to lie to you. Ikenna is used to the Sunday leagues. The
Who's Ikenna? The black boy.
The Bundesliga.
That was so... they told him to say that.
He's giving pleb.
The one with the hair.
The one that said, I probably kissed 15 girls on one night. On one whole night.
You know...
Big what, man.
Bruv, antiseptic. That's all. 15 girls in one night. Name me the whitest club.
Liquid or Time and Envy.
Time and Envy, bro.
What do you know about
Time and Envy, bro? Neck of the woods.
I was Time and Envy a couple of times.
What he was in fucking Kingston.
Listen, you know Time and Envy, in school for us, it was on a first. It was like a Thursday or just a weekday, innit?
Yeah.
So obviously, you got Time and Envy tonight. Yeah, babe, I'm going.
That name is rattling me.
Then you wake up in the morning, you come back to school, and everyone's like, oh my gosh. This person kissed this person. It's because, remember, I'm from Essex, innit? So it's literally my neck of the woods.
No, I've been out in Essex and Northern White areas before. Trust
me. What? Time and Envy on a school night. And I'd lie and tell to my mum, I'm going. You can't tell your mum where you're going.
Rex or something? You lied and tell your mum I'm going Rex?
No, I didn't tell him. I was 16.
Oh, yeah.
Because it's under 18s rave.
Ikenna's the don that leaves with a
wife. He's the don that, you know, like, you go somewhere. And you're like, where's Ikenna?
And he's literally
you see him in the corner. Hey, big man, you just got in here. Yeah. You know them guys, as soon as you get in, you're
you can tell he's a wild card.
Yeah.
I'm not going to lie,
All the stray cats.
I think, I've only watched the first episode. I haven't because I was out.
There's only been two anyway.
I was out on Tuesday. And obviously today we're here. So I forgot to catch up yesterday's one. Do you know what? Not annoyed me, but I thought, Love Island, Joe, you lot are like, you're not allowing it to land the way it usually lands. I don't like the fact that they paired the black people with the black people. Let us just be outraged.
That was a public vote. Apparently.
They're lying. They only done it because they obviously look at how black Twitter has been very vocal about all these things, right? But I feel like it still doesn't, even though we want to see black couples together, it still should just be natural. Like, let Love Island land the way it lands.
But it's all, damned it's all, if you do, damned if you don't.
It's all part of the commentary.
Yeah, you know, the only way it lands, if you get the guys
that like black girls.
Yeah, that you actually.
It's simple.
Yeah, but them niggas ain't applying for Love Island.
Yeah, that's true.
No, they can, but it won't be the guys that the babes want. Mm. You know, like it'll be the babe, the guys.
I've
been waiting for my business for ages, and they're like
the girls that the black girls want to see. Sorry, the guys that the black girls want to see on Love Island, they're not applying. Like the man them niggas, they ain't applying for Love Island.
Ain't Dami.
You know, with
aesthetically,
Dami. No, aesthetically, but not his actual
being, like,
yeah, but I think he's we need to see him kind of develop because I feel like he may have the
mandem.
Yeah, he has elements of it. I think he has.
Is it because he's not from London he's from Ireland though, isn't it? So if you're, I feel like if you're judging him based on like the London like mandem kind of like setup, he's gonna always fall short because he's not from ends.
I think you can still be from, you can be mandem and be from Dublin.
Yeah, but
just a mandem in Dublin.
But it's not the same.
They diet mandem.
Their whole setup is different to us. Have you ever been out of town?
His outfit yesterday was medium.
Been somewhere and like there's brothers there, but when you get there,
the real brothers turn up.
It's like it's not everyone's like, oh shoot, the brothers are here.
And also his piercings play into the fact that he's a bit different as well.
He's got two nose piercings, one nipple piercing. He's got a love heart tattoo on his dick. And he says something like, I have to show them, the man don't believe it until I show them.
Yeah, man don't do that.
Yeah, impossible. The London man are not showing.
That's why I'm saying he's always gonna fall short.
Yeah.
For me, it was the piercings and the piercings straight away. But aesthetically, in terms of
he's
a guy that I would think is decent looking. Like take away the piercings,
yeah,
he's not bad. Like he's nice. He's good to look at. But. Yeah, just
you like him a bit easy.
And can I just quickly? I know this is you lot's podding it, and I feel like I'm just doing the most, and you just want me to be quiet, yeah? Because this is really dumb.
I didn't say nothing, bro.
So I was having this conversation with my friend, yeah, and we're talking about like guys that we like, yeah.
Yeah.
And obviously, this woman was in Ghana, and she lives in Ghana, so we're talking about guys in Ghana. She was like, obviously, she's not Ghanaian, but she's had to adapt and get used to like the accent and like
and
this is the norm in it, so it is what it is. And I said, yeah, like even like me growing up, I'd always laugh at me, like I'd never date a fresh guy with an accent. But like being in Ghana, it's like it is what it is, isn't it? Do you know what I mean? Some worse than others. Sometimes you just think, no. Some you can deal with, some are just it's not gonna work. But then I was talking about American guys, and I was like, you know what, yeah, I have a thing for like I love a New Yorker, like I like the Method Man, do you know what I mean? Like,
bing bong.
What's up, baby? Take me out to dinner. But I'm very, like, do you know what I mean? I was like, yeah. I love the American swag, but sometimes some of the accents can just,
wild.
Yeah. But obviously, nothing beats a Londoner. Like, do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And we're both saying how, like, there's just something about a London guy, a guy from London, and a guy, not even specifically from ends, but just, do you know what I mean? And that's why I say London, like, not even England, London. The swag of London is like, it's so attractive.
Yeah.
And I didn't realize it until I was away from it. And then I came back and I thought, yeah, man, like.
I think it's kind of different for the man then, well, for me anyway. An American girl's accent, super.
Yeah.
I need it. Is it
but
is
don't
a bit
you
gross
find
you?
Sometimes, it's not gross, but gross. I think it's sometimes but, they, not they, but. You know when the ignorance comes through and they sound very like blonde. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, you know what, to be honest, the accent, I would say I agree with you, but they dress like wrestlers.
And yeah, I'm not gonna lie, American
Coco Beware.
No.
Coco Beware back in the day.
American men's dressing.
Papa Shango.
No, don't. Is he African?
He's
African. No, because that name is very Congolese.
Sorry. Mama
Nagai. Literally.
Coco Beware.
No, but you know what I mean about dress? Like they got like, they'll wear like a leotard and some random kicks.
The Booker T dress.
It's not.
You know Koi, she was describing Amber and she went like this.
Oh, Jimmy.
Oh,
quagmire. It was chin.
Oh wow.
No, yeah. You know
it seems to me.
Do you know? Sorry. You know, someone said was she? What's her name? What's Ron Rev's daughter?
Yeah, Angela Simmons.
She also looked like Angela Simmons a little bit.
But the character
of Diggy. Don't kill me.
The character of Diggy.
No, caricature.
Yeah, caricature. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. She said it. When I saw it, I was like, oh my God.
You know, she doesn't look like Andrew Timmons, you know, I just clicked.
Yeah. Is she the one that's
she looks better with less makeup?
Yeah.
The one.
And less clothes. Yeah.
I'm so rude.
Respectfully. No. I know what you mean about the makeup thing. Because I think.
When she came in the house, I was like, cutie. And then she started dressing up in the evening wear, and I was like, this wardrobe's late. Like, take it off. Back bikini me. bikini me. Please. Because
I think I like her because she might have a bit of personality. Mm. She seems like she has.
You think so? Right now, she's giving me dry. It's giving me boring.
No, because I think they was having a little back and forth. Yeah. So then it looked like she may have a personality. And I liked India because when she said, do you like me or do you like me because you're paired with me? I said,
I think India's pretty.
No, she is.
India.
But I like her personality then. When she
but I need that. To. I'm really waiting out to see what she's gonna do with her hair. All of you know, black girls.
Black girls love analyzing people's hair on Love Island.
Yeah, I kept on seeing that too.
Do you know why? Because we want sis to do well, innit?
Yeah.
And the hairstyle she has is not a hairstyle that lasts for long.
Mm.
That's it. It's a pony. Ponies don't last for long in a hot country.
No, that's
really interesting
that you guys are always breaking
down
the haircut,
the hairstyle. Like literally, everyone's like, Ross, what's this gonna do with her hair? Because we're just intrigued. Because we just want. I like her hair now. Yeah. I think it looks nice. I think she's gorgeous.
But don't you give her a little bit of grace because she's like a young dude. Like, what's she?
No, I'm not. 24? I'm not. No, I'm not. We're not judging her. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying. No one has judged her on her. Mm. No, I don't like her hair. It's literally, it goes to show that as black women, we all have the same struggles.
Yeah.
So we're all intrigued because some mama's like, nah, do you know what she should have done? Yeah. Braids. She should have went in there with braids and then taken a wig with her, innit? So like, you know how, and it's not because we're judging. It's just, we all have the same struggles.
You know what's interesting about, even you, because how the women look at it, I'm sensitive, is how I will look at the guys with their game when they're talking to women.
Mm.
I'm like, big man,
why would you say that?
Yeah.
So early?
Yeah.
There was an interaction. I think it was talking about. It was. I can't remember the guy was. He started to work. What's your favorite sex position? In the first place.
Hold on a minute.
It kind of worked. I wouldn't go there.
But where she was describing it, yeah, I was so confused.
What was it called? The broken eagle.
Yeah, broken eagle.
You're doing something. Red cargo, leg up in the air, and something. I'm not gonna lie. Do you know what it gave me? Stranger Things.
Reverse cowgirl with leg up in the air.
Do you watch?
I don't, but
do you?
I just started.
But have you seen how when people are dying, how they die? It's giving me the literally.
Yeah, when she was, but when he said that, I was like, I don't know, bro.
Yeah, what made you go with that verse?
And why would you say that?
But hold on, let's be honest. That only flies with oil bros, in my opinion.
What that question?
That kind of question so early. You think you can? You're telling me that you think you can ask her?
I think he was trying. He went off a vibe that wasn't there. You know that sometimes where guys meet a woman and they're attracted to her. Mm.
You take the conversation where you want it to go.
Yeah,
not
where
it's going.
Not where it actually is. Mm-hmm. So you shoot from far, hoping that she's going to react.
Mm,
and 9 times out of 10, if he's in that bar.
Yeah. I beg your pardon as well.
Most women would have been like, absolutely not. We're not having this conversation. Mm,
yeah. But that can only run on that sort of thing. You can't drop that in a day party.
Because if you heard your guy running that out.
A day party?
Yeah. I mean like a BBN affair.
Also, speaking of guys who are caught lipsing, or guys who lips girls in the club, our friend Bow Wow.
Oh!
Was caught.
Oh, and
necking two shorties.
Shad!
No, it was more.
Shad Mouse.
No, it was. Wasn't even a video of like a group, like there was a group of girls like around, and he was
That was two. Yeah, there was two girls and him.
And when there was one of him doing a girl on her own, I saw a few clips. Like,
and he was taking a young wine as well.
I'm not okay. Cool.
Can I be honest?
He's looking a bit
guys
torso
that,
heavy.
See guys that.
Yeah,
guys
he's
that,
looking chubby.
Yeah.
But he's been looking like that for a while.
Yeah, yes.
Guys that lips girls. Really people, not guys. People that lips strangers in the club. Scare me.
We've all been there though.
I've never lipsed a person in the club.
Yeah,
not
you. I meant us.
I'll stay there. Fuck is you talking about?
I swear still.
No, I'm joking.
No, if you do.
No, Croatia 17, I might have did an opening night. You know, test the waters.
No, you make me sick.
I'm thinking, what's the last year I lipsed a girl?
You walked away. I still got it.
It's really? Y'all make me sick.
I don't remember.
No, Jason, go.
About a long time ago. Very long time ago. Very long time.
I was thinking about
All right, cool. Maybe not the last one, but give me. You must remember one encounter. Tell me how it went. I need to know, because I need to know in your head, yeah? Like, is it like, how does it go? Is it a, oh, I want to lip, I want to taste her lips. Like, how does it?
Nah,
I want to taste her lips.
Like, why do you want to? I want to suck. I want, ooh, them juicy lips.
Do you
like,
know what it is?
About, hold on. Do yeah. you ever move to a girl and you're dancing with her, but you're dancing
nah,
face to
close,
face, and then
no, Yusuff, you're making me sick.
Oh, she's got hit.
Yeah, you trying to serenade from the front?
No. The hand on the small of the back. Anyway, what's the small?
Small of the
small
back.
Of the back. You get me?
Nah, you look make me sick.
The ballroom dancing. What's it called? Ballroom dancing.
No. You know the whining when your legs are in between.
In between, yeah. And you're holding the small of the back.
You know the ones.
No, he's
don't leave me.
I ain't got you there, but turn around.
You never dance in the front of the
girl. In front?
Before?
No, you hold the front.
It's fun, me.
Yeah.
No waste, man.
Okay, take me there. What music is playing right now?
I find it really weird that you don't whine. Like, I'm just looking at each one of you and I'm thinking, I'm just imagining, like,
you know, I find immature when girls say they don't whine because I think it's why are you lying? The right song, right environment, you're going to give someone a cheeky 5 seconds.
Wait, you never danced with a girl from the front?
that's still baffling me.
That's baffling me.
Wait. What song? Take me, what song is playing?
Stand up.
Wait. Slow down, brother.
No, I need to see this. Go on.
Nigga, stand up, nigga.
Cover
my pelvis.
And how are you whining?
Yeah, no, how are you whining? What? You know, thing is, in that
no,
moment,
Yusuff, please show me how you're whining. Because I'm trying to think, is it like a.
No, it's not like that.
That's a bit step on to the streets.
Yeah.
That's a bit, what's his name? Channing Tatum.
So you've never seen two people in the club before? Dancing face to face.
Yeah, you know what? I've got a video for the pod.
You've definitely seen people dance face to face.
I need to know, is it an up and down thing or is it a round and round?
No, it's.
I'll tell you what it's not. It's not this. It ain't that thing.
Is it this?
Why are you looking so stiff like genuine? That could be genuine.
That video is garbage.
No, the thing is, so you might be in a situation where you're talking. You're talking the air, and then the song comes on. You're like, okay, we're here. So that might have happened, and then you know she might hear you.
You know what? You do that because it's gonna get you a laugh, and then she's gonna turn around in a few minutes, in a few seconds.
Sometimes
she's like, she gives you that. What are you doing? And then you kind of guide her to the side.
I don't wind with someone in a minute though.
God damn.
You know what it is with me? Yeah, it's not like Do you know? Can I be honest?
You know the only unladylike.
Do you know the only person I'm winding with? My man.
Husband. Mm.
If I'm with my guy, you can push my head.
Bend me over.
Don't play with me.
How many times have you had a whine and you went to find
a wall? A corner.
You went to find a wall.
Well, like, come here with me?
No, you're annoying.
Wait, explain. What do you mean?
As in,
you need extra
obviously,
support, innit?
The dancing on the back of the wall, for me, that's the best.
Because you've got support.
No, but you was already there or you enjoying the whine so much that you had to go away from the...
Let's just say the girl bucks me here, but the wall's there. I might just do a little backup joint. Just take her to the wall.
Just come to the window, to the wall.
Hey, you might even say, sir, you don't need the wall.
Are you joking? Please. You've actually tapped a man and been like, excuse me.
No, I said, sir, brother,
what's
come
this?
On, man.
My headphone.
Sometimes, like, brother, you're not using this space correctly.
Space, really? I'm not going to, honestly,
are you the guy that goes by the guy and just pops his collar like, I see you, old boy? You ever do that?
You
never do that, bro.
No, you're
not. My sister's calling. Go off, bro.
But you won't greet a guy in the office.
I'll lie.
You said that 3 episodes in a row now.
Yes.
Get over.
No. Get over. You go and pop a stranger's collar when he's whining with someone or
even to
a girl.
You have to do it.
But a new guy comes into your office, you won't
sometimes
greet
you know
him.
Dickheads. It's nice when you see something. You know, we see a guy enjoying himself.
Yeah.
I love it.
Like,
man.
I get what he said. I don't.
Yeah, do you went over. You think, yeah, but you don't
good
go
job.
And go.
Happy calendar, let him such a.
Do you know, I helped a guy get a number once. I think it might have been Ghana. He was chatting to her babes, and she wasn't even. She was a bit unresponsive, but I saw. You know when he's like, I really want you to get that number, man.
So what did you do?
So I went over to him. No, brother. Mm. You see, my guy, it's my fucking nigga since birth.
Oh, I did that.
Real
I've,
one.
I've done it before.
I respect you, fam. Love. Yeah. Then she started be like, okay, he gets homage out here in these streets. You know what
I'm saying?
I've done that before.
Is it?
I ain't no dude.
More so to my friends, not to more strangers.
Okay, no, but I've helped a stranger before. Like, is that some. He didn't. I think he and this girl had a little. You might have seen her before, took her number, not called her.
Yeah. Mm.
And I just said, I said, but he lost his phone.
Yeah.
I said, but he was meaning to call, and daddy met you, blah, blah. Then later on, he found me. He's like, Hey, bro, you want a shot?
You see?
Yeah,
I love it, man. Patternization is a beautiful thing.
As long as, bro, I just want you to win.
Yeah.
Just
can girl, I say that?
Girl, like, girls do it as well, though.
Can I just say that that is beautiful, though? Like, for me, to me, that's black boy joy. It's cute. Like,
them
dancing
ass
niggas
on Instagram.
Here when you don't talk about it, it's cute.
I remember my first ever girlfriend, I met her at a club. And there was another girl who I was with as well, like a group of us, isn't it? When she saw us talking, she came up to us. She gave me, fam, all the flowers, bruv. Like, she proper, like, bigged me up. And I think, funny enough, it actually worked. I thought I was really in there. But her, kinda her speech...
Did she know you?
Who?
The girl.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, no. Like, I feel like when it comes from girls, it's probably more... Like, it's more because...
Her speech tipped the balance.
Because my thing is, yeah, let me be honest. If you come and chat for him... I'm taking what you're saying with a pinch of salt because I understand bro code.
Yeah,
and I understand that
when a girl does it, you're
man
like, okay.
them is man them, innit? But when I see, if a woman came up to me and said, sis, you know what, a style guy, like he's perfect, whatever.
Girls love
I'm gonna literally, okay, sis, you sealed the deal because I know that she's coming, she gets it.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. And she has your best interest at heart.
Yeah, and she's not looking out for her. Not like she's not looking out, even if that's her, like, because for me, if I know my guy's trash, my bedroom's trash and he's moving to a girl, I'm not wingmaning you because you're trash.
Damn.
I'm just not doing it. I'm gonna leave you to it.
Yeah.
But if I know my boy's good and I see him trying to chat to a girl and I think he's a good dude, I'm coming over and I'm adding extra pepper.
Extra spice.
But if you're trash, you're not getting a word from me. However, with you lot, not gonna lie, you lot don't, like, even if your guy's trash, you see him moving to a girl, you come in and vim, do you know what I mean?
If I know the girl.
No, even if you don't know her, you will come and lie for your mans. That's the point I'm making.
I'll leave the tennis. I let every fisherman fish for themselves.
Yeah.
I like
This is back in the day stuff.
Yeah, I like everyone to fish for themselves. The worst is actually when you see that you see a guy moving to a girl.
Yeah.
You want him to get the girl. You can overhear the conversation and you're like, why did you go with that first?
You know what? Let's keep it a buck. How many times have you seen a guy move to a girl that you wanted to move to and you were salty? Be honest.
I weren't salty, but I did something that wasn't.
What did you do? Dirty Maca.
I did some dirty Maca.
Basically, I just sick man.
I wish
Joe Thomas.
Why Joe Thomas?
He's a dirty Maca.
Is he?
Yeah.
The singer.
Is he? All of his songs are about if I was your man.
Oh, it's true.
Do you not remember the video? I want to know when the guy had the argument with his
girlfriend. Argument with the girl, and he just got in
and he was waiting by the side.
Yeah,
go on
with his fucking two way and some shit.
Yeah, he took a two way number. Yeah.
But there was a girl at a bar. I must have seen her. Okay, she's all right. And then like we looked at each other.
Yeah.
And then this guy came and started talking to her. So I went near the bar near her, and I was like, you know you got better options, right?
Oh.
But she giggled.
The Smith.
She giggled.
That nigga that she has.
Little Drake, I'll be having that.
She's light skin. What do you expect?
I am dark skin. And then she laughed, looked at him. He looked like, what did he say? And I was like, no. And I just carried on. And after, I spoke to after.
I respect it. Do your thing. Each to their own. I think, you know, one thing I'm learning, that maybe I need to shoot my shot. Jesus Christ, it rattles me.
Please do.
Maybe.
There's been a certain someone you've been.
I know.
You got. You don't even have to shoot. This
I've got a cross.
Strategic.
So
I have a few crushes.
Goddamn.
Okay.
Not a few.
Roster of crushes.
No, but as in like.
Starting five.
No, I mean, you had this conversation. Do you remember when I was like. The thing with me is, it's a confidence thing.
Mm. What's
I don't know. I just always...
Like, have you ever switched up before in your life?
Never in my life.
Is it?
Never. And if I think a guy's good looking, I always think, he's got, he must have options. It's long, there's no point.
It's long, single.
No, literally, legitly.
No, you should never think that.
Yeah, but look at the conversation we had the other day.
Absolutely.
And no, I was just like, nah.
No, but the thing is, the reality is, most good looking guys do have options. It's whether or not they actually, you know, what's what I'm looking for?
Plausible.
As, are they actively engaging with the options?
Yeah, fair enough. Some people might even engage the options.
Yeah.
And maybe even take it as anything. Like, you know, some people, you're looking at him, he's got options. Yeah. But he's looking like,
I don't like my options. Right?
Do you know what it is? I think it's the same with me because people assume that, like, I have loads of options and there's guys lining up to date me and stuff like that. And there is, guys. But they're not guys that I'm That's what I'm saying. Yeah. So I need to also understand that it goes both ways.
It's the same principles. I think because sometimes, you know, and the whole thing. Women think that men like anything.
Yeah.
So
ain't true.
It's definitely not true. But because of that, if they don't think it's the same principle, men might be like, oh, I like the motorcycle runner. I'm just chilling. But I don't really, I'm not going to entertain. So that's why they were. But I think also it's a strategic positioning as a lady, as a woman, just putting yourself in the shot view so that person can shoot at you or even have a general conversation, because they might be like, oh, shoot, hold on. That's your kind of dope.
To piggyback off that, yeah, I remember one funny word, I know. What's it called?
To piggyback off your
I hate it, bro. I don't know why I say it. What's it called? I remember one, because it even came on my, what would you call it, Snap stories 2 years ago, your bank holiday trending.
Oh my gosh. That came up on mine. Yeah, and I kept, and my Snap was like, I'm too old to be here.
Yeah, that one, yeah.
Oh, I came with you, innit?
Yeah.
What's
it called? I was there actually as well. I came with.
The Liverpool Street one, innit?
Yeah.
Okay. So what's it called? I'm there. I'm going by the bar, get my little mix and coke. And this girl standing beside me, 40 fags, that one.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. And she's just like, so what are you drinking then? And I'm like, okay, you're not too bad, actually. Boom, 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 boom. I was like, no, I'm just going to get my little rum and coke. Boom, 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 boom. Ended up buying her a drink. Cool. Started chatting. This, that, and the third. To me, that is the lightest of shooting your shot. Because, of course, if you're worth it, I will take over. Yeah,
you gotta pay attention.
But then, I remember I told one girl who was, like, struggling to shoot a shot. I said, this is the bare minimum that you can do. And her view on it, and I think this is a lot of other girls' view, is that if you did not notice me before I said something, you didn't really take
I'm going to be honest. Yeah. I see it as... And it's dumb because if it's, it is dumb because it's not, you're not visible to everybody, innit?
Yeah.
So it is a dumb thing. But I do think sometimes like, oh, like, if you haven't approached me, then you clearly don't find me attractive. So what's the
type of city mentality is
bro, that? I didn't clock you. There's bare people in the dark.
I didn't clock you. Sometimes guys are just chilling. Mm. And they're like, I don't know if you're approachable yet. I don't know if we can even have an exchange. We need to like build some rapport.
Mm.
Unless it's like, I see you. I want you.
I likes you.
I likes you. I want you.
Yeah.
You can do this the hard way
or the easy way. The choice is yours.
But unless it's that, sometimes guys are like, okay, you might, oh, she's nice, but I haven't had any sort of engagement.
Mm.
So I can't just got cold calling. You know, like, cold calling is a bit...
Hit and miss.
It's very hit and miss.
Because a lot of guys, they're mustering up the courage to even try this.
That's the thing as well.
Yeah. A lot of guys are... generally mustering up the courage. Not everybody is comfortable talking to women.
Yeah, exactly.
But, and that sounds really bad. It sounds
that's
another one. Go on,
I
don't want him anyway. You've been a confident man.
Oh, knock it off.
That's
bro, what girls have always got a caveat, bro.
Yeah.
You found me.
Found me.
No, I've heard that like so many different times. Well, I don't want you if you're not confident enough to talk to me.
Yeah, but it's layered.
No, but you know why? It's because like, You want a man, innit? Or a man to be a man's man. Like, my thing is, I always get told, oh, guys are intimidated by you. And I'm like, all right, cool. Then you're not the ones I want. I don't want a guy to be intimidated by me. I don't want you to be intimidated by, like, my drive or my ambition or, you know what I mean?
No, but this guy doesn't know you. He'll know you have drive and ambition. He just might not be confident enough to approach you in that moment. Maybe give him some time.
Yeah, he might
need a couple of drinks down his system.
Maybe.
His song might need to come on.
I'm one of them.
My song.
Going to a dance.
It might be a thing of, like, he's just... he's there and some guys analyze. Yeah. I know a lot of guys do it. They might look at find a woman attractive. They might analyze first before they move.
Yeah.
Cause that's how they are. They're like, I'll wait. See
why is sell back? I can't afford that bitch.
Right, hold on. So if a guy clocks
she
you,
rich.
She rich, rich.
How long after he clocks you do you expect him to come and talk to you? Like, can the nigga wait an hour or is it has to be
straight away? No, I don't even like I don't even expect you to like see me and come and approach me straight away.
Yeah.
Honestly. And again, with me, if it's in like in a public setting, like an event, whatever, I'm proper shy. Like I hate spotlight. So you can't come, like if you want, do you know what I mean? It's not like, even at the end of the dance when everyone's leaving, I feel that's even worse because it's like everyone's watching. It's just, there's too many eyes.
You know what? Throughout the years I learned,
extra time
is the best.
It's not. because you're
it can work.
The scraps.
I remember you.
Tap-ins.
No, no, no. You have to
park
no,
a lot.
Yeah, park a lot.
No, but there's
my girlfriend, but
there's a theory to that though.
Mm-hmm.
Because, okay, most of the then really like really yeah. leave just before yeah. closing.
Yeah.
Some will still hang around. And then
good times, good stuff.
You're smiling too hard, man. Man just turned his head like
you gotta catch the peg things before they got into their mercs and that.
About the whole time, isn't it?
I hear that.
Parking lot people
and
were
and
fun.
And generally,
man said parking lot pimping.
And then generally after, it's as a fisherman you use your tools. So some
man said fisherman.
No, because some men are right fisherman. At the door.
Yeah.
But that's not may not be the best light for you to. To get in,
you gotta catch him on the adjacent.
I'm not gonna lie, I've done door before, you know.
Yeah, don't, no, I've done door. Another thing is, you work
door, yeah.
You
harsh.
Work it out sometimes, you work out.
Security
man.
Man,
it's harsh.
Doors, because when you're at the door, I hate it. And she's like, oh.
Yeah, like, whoa.
Okay.
Whoa, buddy.
Energy. Yeah. Energy. You're
so aggressive.
But sometimes I think, I don't know, what I learned before is that sometimes you might wanna have a little engagement just before the end. Yeah, so if she sees you outside, you can
she'll remember you and you've had that before,
you can have a little exchange, etc. And if someone is if she's in danger with some a guy, I don't know what they die, she might look at you like, oh, you can save me. Intro dip.
Yeah.
But it all depends.
That same story. Remember when I got into little fisticuffs in Croatia?
Yeah.
Because listen, this is a disclaimer. I was protecting black bitches before it was fashionable. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Wait, I saw the fisticuff was when CJ got sprayed.
Because I called him.
Okay.
This is the story.
Yeah.
There's one girl that I saw at Bootylicious. She was talking to one gentleman and I met her the day before and she was looking uncomfortable. And this is about day 5. I remember this because I had my Moncler hat on backwards. Oh. Boom, now. Came in there, shorts, real thick, you know, looking like Nick Cannon. And, you know what I'm saying?
Nick Cannon.
I'm looking like Nick Cannon. I came in, you know, swagging. I wasn't cool. He's chatting to her and he's touching her all on her navel and that.
Mm.
I'm looking at it and she's looking at it like, Kojo, what's hitting me? So I'm like, big man, I think she's not interested. Of course, what? Nigga, about 185 pounds.
Nigga, whose is you?
Nigga, what? And he was like, and then he started, you know, man, I'm from Brixton, bruv. I'm from the hill, bruv. I said, okay.
I don't sorry,
know,
sir.
Sorry, Brixton sir. Boy. I don't know who you are. So then he mushed me in my head. Mushed me backwards. Yeah. Hat came off, trim was expired, long story. So then.
And a 5-day trim.
You know what there was? 5 days is gone. So now. In my head, the first thing I said is, okay, I'm about to get real raw right now. But let me analyze that these boys in the vicinity are not his boys because this could be a Russian.
Yeah.
So I clocked. I said, nope, he looks like nobody. I went to go. I said, CJ. CJ was fucking listening to suspects. You know, CJ standing on the table.
Yeah.
I said, see, he looked at me. He said, after the fact, he was like, I've never seen your face like that. CJ jumped off immediately. Yeah. And then that's when David was about.
Yeah.
And he was like, which one is it? I was like, that one, Adidas shorts. Yeah. So that's when I ran up to him. Yeah. Then I took my 9 out and I shot him. And then was a good. I remember it was Westwood's pool party.
Yeah.
The latest day of the whole event. So what's it called? After all of that, she's on the sideline. Everyone's got the camera phones. And then apparently Lukeman and Kenny was like, nah, leave him. We know him, bro. He's cool. And I was like, nah. I hate man that acts for girls, bro. So I'm there. I'm engaging in fisticuffs, roughing him up. I'm roughing him up. So it wasn't cool. And then Lukeman must have pulled me off. And then that's when Polisha for the security guards come with the pepper spray.
Policia.
Who caused all of that?
It was me. So I locked up the dance by accident. I still got the video. I'll show it to you. Somebody recorded it. It was on a blog
because
site.
Of that.
Because
but I'm not gonna lie though. Yeah, you can't mush me in my head. No,
but
dumb.
That's impossible.
But even Taser and his boys were getting into 50. Were getting into.
I swear.
Are you sure it was the same?
Oh, wait,
the same
did it really cause a whole
ruckus? I might start
the same day.
So afterwards, people were just fighting. Yeah, people.
Taser and his boys. We were here. They were above, behind us.
Mm-hmm.
They were getting to it with the bouncers, the pepper spray, fam. It was. It reached me and I wasn't even close to it.
It's not purpose, and you purpose don't know what to do.
Apparently,
you don't put what you need milk.
It's like, you know what's mad about that? Yeah. Even the whole saving thing. Because you don't realize sometimes when you're saving, the ramifications after.
Yeah, because it's on you, you know.
That happened when, so probably when we got locked down and we kind of was let out a little bit at one of my friend's events. To be fair, we was running joke, but basically this guy was talking to this girl for ages. She was straight faced. This.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
So as me and Rachel were talking, I said, "Rah, she ain't laughed once, you know."
Stiff face.
Just
tough.
So I said to sometimes her friend, not time. Her, yeah. I said, "You need to save her, man. Like, man, he's had his time. Yeah. 5 minutes is up, man. Come on." Yeah. And then after, like, he weren't letting. So went to the car, and we was gonna go drive off, but the guy and like basically him and his cousin were literally
hounding
down the road. So it was like, is it cool? Mm. How are you getting home? Blah blah blah. Just why do we do that, guy? Do you know where I'm from?
Male ego. Sometimes
I was like, brother, you don't care. Like, and the thing is, in this scenario, I'm the one that's like making sure everyone like whatever. He's the guy's lent on locks. Yeah. Locks is he's got that thing of I'm not a dickhead. Yeah. So locks is gonna start like the guy. I said, "No, guys, everybody chill." Da da da. Like, I'm in between.
Mm.
The other guys come. And what is it? Da da da. And then he comes up, but I've said, "Guys, chill." He's like, I'll do." I was like, "Brother, I'm keeping the peace for your sake,
mm-hmm.
not because I feel as for your sake." So I think this is whatever. And then after the girls went home, but this guy basically it started off a whole little thing where lots went into the venue, got a broom, and other people came out, and then on the high road, basically the whole high road was locked off because people thought there was going to be scuffle just because of the saying to the guys, "Come on, chill."
It's a hard decision if you need to check a man because the threat of violence
is
sometimes you have to intervene.
No, you have to, but it's the threat of violence is always around the corner.
Mm. Yeah. All right. Our friend Michael B is in the
town. What happened? Now. How comes I didn't even know this yet? Someone was like, I saw a tweet and it was just like, one thing about Lori Harvey is she's the quickest, like bare jokes about her like getting over guys and how she's deleted all his pics. And I was just like, they're not together.
But I heard a theory though on the Joe Budden podcast that I want to share.
Okay, go on.
The theory is that relationship was a ruse.
A ruse. Oh no, but I saw that.
Do you think so?
So basically, prior to them being together, Michael B had a lot of like gay rumors around his name.
Right. I do remember that.
Mm.
His image wasn't the best.
Where did the rumors stem from? But I do remember, like,
and I think there's also a narrative that he preferred white women as well.
Okay.
Yeah, then, I remember that now.
Yeah. So then Joel was saying how this was orchestrated
Brandon.
In the boardroom. They put this together as a publicity stunt to aid both their careers, especially Michael B, and they had the expiration date on it. And it hit that date and it's up. And that it was kind of a thing where he was allowed to be the person to give the reasons why they broke up. Because apparently the story
why
is
did they break up?
That he proposed to her. He was taking it seriously. He wanted to buy a house together. He obviously he's 10 years, he's 35, she's 25, isn't it?
Oh, is he?
So the narrative is that he wanted to take it to the next step. And she's like, "You know what? No, I still want to have fun. I'm still out here in the streets. This is too serious for me. I'm out.
I'm not leaving."
Yeah.
I am not leaving.
So that's for the sake of the conversation, let's pretend that it wasn't a publicity stunt.
And it's real.
This is real.
Okay.
And Lori Harvey and him have broken up.
Okay, so this based on those reasons, I think that's also part of the age gap dilemma.
Yeah.
With dating, like very largely. You know what I mean? Having a big age gap.
Yeah, she dated Diddy. It was a bigger age gap there.
No, I feel like I'm surprised. I think she's a different kettle of fish. You see her?
Yeah. Now, Lori Harvey is...
Like, her roster is...
She's cold-blooded. Yeah,
but I think she's just dating.
No, I think she's just dating.
And you got to, like... She may be a hybrid because who her stepfather is.
Yeah.
And who her mum is.
I'm like Steve.
Her mum is a killer.
Who's her mum?
Remember her mum from... Where is she from? Remember, she's the one that dated the two brothers. Is it two brothers or cousins?
No idea.
They're not...
I know what you're talking about.
They're when one fell off, she dated the other.
Is it?
Yeah, she's cold hot. Like,
if these are her two examples, Mr. Think Like a Man and Miss Savage over here, no wonder she turned out the way she is.
Yeah.
But I think she's the young
she's
girl.
She's stunning.
No, she's a young girl, but for me, it's dating Diddy and Jay and Justin. That's what I'm like.
Yeah, that's
father and son.
Lack of principle.
The principles and the morality here is a bit wayward to me. Everything else, I don't care. Yeah. But it's the Diddy and the Justin thing.
Because you're having sex with them, let's be honest.
Yeah.
Of course, exactly. So it's just like, you said.
Father and son duo. Yeah.
Can you imagine you're just in the house? Oh, no, no, I got
wrong room.
I gotta go this way.
Yeah.
No, it's tough.
It's long.
And in that industry, these things are just.
It's normal, innit?
It's normal, innit? So I'm sure Justin and Diddy had a conversation just like that. Go true, pops.
Yeah. You got it, Papa.
I think if that is, let's say that's a real valid thing about, like, you know, him wanting to get serious and she's not wanting to get serious. Yeah. I think it's an unfortunate reason to no longer be together, but it is what it is, isn't it? It's like, you can't. I respect it in the sense of not settling.
Yeah.
Or not compromising what you really want. I have to respect that because I'm a prick. So, no, but like, I'm the kind of person who will compromise.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I really, whenever I see people like not settle and, do you know what I mean? Yeah. And go and pick the harder option.
Yeah.
I respect it so much. And I wish I had that kind of like, that vim, do you know what I mean?
Yeah. And also, Laurie was, she was engaged to Memphis Depay for time.
Yeah.
Her first boyfriend, like the basketball player or whatever.
Footballer.
Yeah.
But to be honest, he probably saw her
and
was like, this needs
snatch
to be
her up real quick.
This needs to be me.
Memphis, he was with her before she was even famous.
Yeah. He was,
you know what I mean?
And he was very, he's a proud man.
Yeah.
So I think
Actually, she must have been very young then because she's only 25 now. And she was with Memphis
years ago.
Probably like when she was 19.
She must be must be about 19.
19.
18, 19 when she
was and he was probably about 23.
Yeah, young.
He was
young still.
But you know what's mad? It's the whole, you know, the clip that's going around of him at the basketball game.
No, it's Cordae's making it worse.
Yeah.
What clip?
So there's a clip of Michael B. Jordan at a basketball game. He's looking like he's
sad.
Upset, sad, is whatever. It? But he's with Cordae rapping. And Cordae's like, yeah, my man's just hit me up last minute, says he got a spare ticket to the game. You know,
and
we're here.
Like, ha, ha, ha. And that moustache is throwing me off as well, bro.
Yeah, like, going through. So people are saying that that ticket was meant for Laurie.
Yeah, and he got
but
now they broke it up, now he gave it to Cordae. But why would you do that? Why would you be like, yo, me, my man's hit me up last minute?
But you know, guys are insensitive in that moment. Because it was like, you broken up? Okay, don't worry. We got you back out.
You're going out tonight. You know,
That's like when Omarion broke out of April, isn't it? And Bawa was like, don't worry.
Yeah.
In the comments, we're going to go strip club. And April was like, what the fuck is this? Like, she kind of came out in a minute.
But then hold on a minute. So do you think it's fake? Or do you think it's genuine? Like, do you think their relationship? Because I genuinely thought, my man's doing up love. Like, I feel like with Laurie, I'm used to Laurie being in relationships and stuff, innit? But
the thing is, I can imagine the story of him proposing to her and her being like, you know what?
Am I too young?
Yeah, because think about it. She's just jumping from man to man to man. Like, there hasn't been much gaps between.
At all.
Was there a big gap between Future and Michael B. Jordan? There wasn't a big gap. Was there a big gap between Diddy and Future? Like, to me, Laurie Harvey is having fun
and
she's dating and she's doing her thing, innit? Because there aren't big gaps between these relationships.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? She's having fun.
She's having fun, and because she knows that she'd want it, it's hot.
But do you know what's also really mad, right? Yeah. She's generally not doing anything wrong, though.
I don't think anyone says she is.
No.
Because she's Laurie Harvey.
To be fair, she's one of the girls.
Because she's Laurie Harvey. Yusuff, if we're in ends and there's a girl in ends, who moves like Laurie Harvey, as in relationship from relationship to relationship, let's be honest, man, then will have something to say about it. Like, if every time. Is that they would.
But then you wouldn't. The thing is, the difference is because Laurie is almost a public figure. We know who she's dating. Because people can do that. Yeah. You can date.
I get it.
The degrees of separation is very small.
And also, I think it's because how she carries herself as well.
Yeah.
Like, I don't even know how she sounds.
I don't know.
Like her voice. I don't know her voice.
I think I heard one thing when just talk about Pilates.
Pilates.
Oh, yeah.
And that's like a whole debate.
Okay, about that. She carries herself well, in my opinion.
Like, you don't hear any fuck.
When you mean say well, what do you mean by well?
As in, okay, there's no salacious fuckery stories. It's just who she's dating.
There's no drama.
They do extravagant things and then they break up.
There's no drama around her name.
There's no stories. Nothing in her stories.
So do you think, are you sure? Because honestly, I find it hard to believe. Do you know why I'm saying this? No, I'm saying this because I feel like in society, right? Mm. If you're a woman who dates like who is seen as someone who's continuously dating or like has several boyfriends,
yeah.
regardless of whether they're your boyfriends or not,
yeah.
you're gonna get a rep, or people are gonna start having okay. things to say okay. about you.
But why doesn't Erykah Badu have that rep? Why doesn't Rihanna have that rep?
Yeah. My point is, like I said, because they're celebrities. I just said.
No, but there's some celebrities who do have the rep.
Yes.
No,
I think Laurie does have that rep. Even J-Lo had the rep a bit.
It depends. Alfanos.
they have the rep, but maybe you want them to have it.
The thing is, worse. I think they have a rep. They may have a rep, but because it's, I think it is what you said as well. How they carry themselves.
Yeah.
Because you can do that. You can date whoever you want to date continuously. It may be how messy you leave a situation.
Yeah.
That's fair.
That puts that on you.
Which I get, but I guess for me, I just feel like women outside of like celebrityhood can't live by the same standards because they get judged a lot harsher. Do you understand what I mean? So, yes, Rihanna, but I'm always seeing it as because these guys are celebrities, it's kind of just like, do you know what I mean? It's normal.
Maybe.
And then,
and I think supreme pretty privilege plays a part.
Again, that as well.
It does play a part.
She's upper echelon buffers.
But then you give her a blind. In the ends, maybe some girls that are highly sought after.
Mm.
I'm sure when they break up with their guy, there's a list of guys running after them, or they may be still going on restaurant dates, etc.
Yeah.
It's just that we may not be that. As you said, leads into pretty privilege. Ah, well, obviously someone's gonna go and date her again.
Yeah.
It depends on how you carry yourself. If you're dating, you know, multiple guys and there's stories and things coming out of it, then people are like, oh, it's a bit much. And yes, people, regardless, I think, of celebrity or not, people are gonna talk. So in their circles, they're like, Rush, let me go another date again.
Yeah.
They're probably talking.
Yeah, and also I think American culture and British culture, we're different.
Yeah, like, 100%.
In America, they are a lot more free, normal. That stuff there is normalised, isn't it? So
yeah.
I feel like over here, we are a lot more judgmental as British people in general.
Yeah.
So that's, I think that maybe does also play a part in maybe why people aren't as forthcoming. But I just want to kind of like pivot a bit. Right?
I'll ask a question before you got off this topic. Mm-hmm. I'm going to say, who do you think is going to be her next boo?
Her next partner.
Like who in the entertainment world would you say, you know what, that would be a good pair for Laurie next?
I think she might go into the basketball or NFL. She might try that.
I was gonna say an athlete.
NFL.
Who you say?
You know, I don't know any athletes.
Oh no, you know what? Maybe basketball.
Who?
Jay.
I don't know. Is she 25?
Okay.
She can get anyone. Zion Williamson.
Not Zion.
Oh. Little fat boy.
Miles Bridges.
You might go there.
Zion, nah, man.
Nah, not Zion.
Care about his chickens.
Nah, if Laurie dated the basketball player, it will be Jason Taylor.
That's
he's got a
baby. I don't know, but I'm not sure if he's with the woman. But
okay, I think.
Yeah, if he gets this ring,
Jason Taylor will be a shout, you know, because I think they're the same age as well.
You're a bit younger, but
I think she's older than him by a year, maybe.
Yeah, probably. Yeah,
I think just Google Jason Taylor.
Jason,
that's the definitely
maybe basketball.
Yeah, she's gonna try take her talents to the league.
But Drake,
would never.
Nah.
Why? Drake, you know who Drake is? Drake is a collector.
He might knock it down, but I don't think he's gonna be.
Her and Jason would be cute.
Yeah,
I think Drake would probably try to run it down.
Yeah, Meek's.
Meek's been friend out there. But
yeah, no, she ain't.
I can't. She's not going to Meek. He's too fucking a family for her.
I think Future
has a cleaner image in terms of like, I don't see Future as a thug, if that makes sense. Okay, do you know what I mean? I feel like Meek is very rough around the edges, like fucking family. I just see Future as toxic.
And plus, Meek too messy. Like,
You're right, because Future's not messy. But Future is messy, no?
But do we think that Laurie will be intrigued about Meek because Meek bagged Nicki? You know, some girls, they, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You bagged Nicki, so there must be something about you.
But then, because the way Meek tweets and stuff, like, Laurie doesn't got, like,
he's childish.
He's too
in his,
a tweeting
and
man.
There's nothing wrong with being in your feelings, yeah, but it's like he just, he projects.
Yeah,
and sometimes it's not. You don't.
They'd break up. We'd know about it at 2 a.m.
Yeah. Yeah.
Why?
Yeah. 2 a.m.
She don't want me.
Bitch ass.
Yeah. It would be. Yeah.
I have an inkling she's gonna be with like a white guy. Like one of them good looking white men.
She might try like a mogul, like an oil guy on a Rihanna thing.
Maybe.
Possible. I see it.
Possible still. Sorry, you were gonna say something.
Oh, so I saw a video the other day of I think it was Sierra and she was twerking and stuff here. And I was like, do you know what I don't like here? How over sexualized thick black women are, yeah? And hear me out.
Okay, hear me out. This bag.
Yeah.
Oh,
here's the thing. Situation, yeah, because I was like,
you land,
because I was comparing it and I was like, look at Carisha and them, like, do you know who that is?
Well, Carisha from the
City Girls, City Girls. Oh, like, okay. young Miami is called Carisha,
yeah.
I thought you said Carucci, so
no, Carisha, but
say she, yeah.
People only call her Carisha, like City Girls, City Girls, they've got bomb, they've got bunda.
She got a little, I thought he was gonna say Aisha the Dawn.
No, so when I say fit girls, I'm just talking about because. Sierra doesn't have like a booty in my opinion, and she's quite athletic, right?
But that thing
and
then, moving.
Sport.
Sport booty.
And obviously, you've got the Meg Thee Stallions, the Cardi B's, the BBL girls.
It's looking like Meg. No, Meg. She's looking a bit.
She's lost weight. Yeah.
Meg's not a BBL girl.
That's
no, but I'm saying Meg, but Meg is a twerker. Yeah. Like, do you get what I'm trying to say? Yeah. She's a stallion though.
Yeah, but
even though she ain't got a big bum, she's thick, she's solid.
She built.
And I'm not just talking about BBL girls, but I'm just giving you like the difference in like the women, right? Yeah. And I feel like when Sierra dances, she can be as sexual as she wants and pop that, right? And there's no slack in terms of like
it's choreographic.
It's not sexualized. It's seen as art or it's, do you know what I mean? And to me, she's not really doing anything different to like the others. Because she's twerking on the top of a car, like shaking her ass.
But she a dancer.
Yeah, but
it's in the routine.
No, because it's not dance routines though. So when she's doing videos where she's topless, yeah. So you remember the Joro challenge where girls are doing the Wizkid Joro and she's whining and TikToking and whatnot, and she's topless from the back and she's wearing something on her bum. It's a challenge that was going around.
Oh, yeah. I was trying
but
to
again, that's not choreography. That's like showing us what you're working with. Those kind of vibes. Showing us you've got them good knees. My point is, women like her, and it's not even just her, because I feel like, even if you are white, it's the same thing. Like, you're not sexualized. Like, it's just like, oh, like you can do those things and get away with it. Whereas if you're someone who has a bit more meat and body, instantly, it's like, oh, you're a thought, or like you're twerking. Like, there's a lot of negative connotations that come with it.
From who?
Do you think?
From who?
Yeah, I'm
listening to you. I'm thinking.
Yeah, I'm listening.
Where is this going?
Do you know why you don't get it? Maybe it's because I've had conversations with other women who get my point.
Yeah, but okay, cool. Where are these women being slandered?
By who?
Like, is it in the comments? Is it like
so for like men who will say stuff like. Like, city girls will twerk and be like, oh, the girls of this age, this is your idol. Like, my woman could never be dancing like this or whatever, whatever. You will never catch a man, or guys aren't going to take you serious and da da da.
I think Sierra's a bad example because
she's from dance.
She's a dancer. We look at Sierra as a dancer. Whenever she does anything, just looking at it as dance.
Yeah.
So maybe not you, Sierra.
So that's why when you say I was thinking, and I kind of agree, I was like, if it was Kelly Rowland, you'd be like, Kelly Rowland just dancing. It's choreographed.
And she's not a dancer. But,
okay, cool. But I think
but
that more speaks to how we see that person.
Yeah.
Kelly Rowland and Sierra are very like esteemed human beings. We look at them
so
like.
So if it was Shakira, are we kind of.
She's
a dancer.
No, I think Shakira would be the same group as Kelly Rowland and Sierra.
Yeah, because the way they, like, the thing is.
But I think they feel her, especially.
But they carry themselves different, though. As I don't know if. They carry themselves differently as women in general. So when they do certain things, you're like, okay, cool, you're just doing like, whatever.
Yeah.
But when it comes to maybe the City Girls, Meg, like generally they
Cardi.
Like for example, if I saw you twerking, Gina, I know you're an esteemed human being. I mean, so I'm not thinking, look at this fuck. I'm thinking that's Gina.
He gonna be like, knock it off.
Put it away.
But that's you. And that's the relationship you have.
No, but I genuinely think that about Gina too. Because if, like, Gina's, I'm like, okay, I might run a joke, but then I'll be like, Gina, like, I wouldn't think anything
like,
of it.
You carry yourself well in life, so I'm not looking at you like,
but
look at this.
Example,
do you think
you see,
so, though? Yes. Because you, no, not saying, no.
But I think example,
that came out
Meg?
Wrong.
Can yeah. I go to Meg?
She said, please.
Example.
I'm a heathen.
and even with Meg, that's her brand. Even that's, with that's Meg to I don't think bad of it.
You don't, yeah?
No, that's her brand. Because I'm not going to lie to you. That's that's partly that keeps the lights on.
To be fair, I don't think any guy in this room, I don't look at any girl twerking as a bad thing.
No, no, and you know what?
That's you then.
Yeah, just girls having fun, man.
Yeah, just let women twerk, be. Baby. You know, the thing is, I think it comes from a bit.
No, it's the Volvic. It's seven alkaline.
This guy,
yeah, I think it becomes maybe
speak
too,
your chest. Speak of your chest.
Yeah. Too judgmental in terms of like, do what you're doing, dance.
If there's a girl that you liked, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, let me ask you like this.
I go.
There's a girl that you liked or you had your eye on and you saw her on her snap with her girls or whatever, or you saw whatever and she's dancing, she's twerking and having fun and just being ratchet with her friends as you do. Is that going to turn you off her?
How buff is she? No, I'm joking. I'm joking. No, it wouldn't, because she's just with her girls having
fun. Yeah, that's what you're
doing. Don't shake your head, because I know for a fact. I know you. Yeah. I do know you.
No, she's just having fun.
Just having fun.
The thing is, it's regularity.
It's the regularity. And like he said, because he knows you in.
But listen to the person you don't know.
Okay, cool. Is she an A girl? Because she's an A girl by definition and by
what's an A girl?
You had an ick. You had a similar male ick.
A girls are by they're ick.
What's an A girl? What is the definition of A girl?
As soon as it's 5 p.m. on Friday, you're running.
Girls are always up in the club every weekend talking about A girls.
Someone said, I can come up. So people think I'm an A girl.
I can see
and
why.
I'm really not. Wow, man said, I can see why.
Look, because you're all up in the clouds doing.
You're out of order. No, I don't actually.
You don't. You live for this thing.
I'm an A girl.
No, I don't think you're an A girl.
No, I wouldn't see an A girl.
No,
but
I'm
you know,
not.
The thing is, you know what A girls are? You know them? You know, A girls are like, they all, A girls have a motive. After the motive.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
after
no.
the motive.
There are some girls that I follow on Instagram who are at motives every single weekend. Like, literally.
It comes across that way for me though, and it's sad because
hey, girls.
I will have days off here where I'm not out and people are like, oh, out again. I'm thinking, bro, I didn't go out. I haven't been out in
no,
ages.
Enjoy your life.
Enjoy your life.
But what we're saying A girls are is
go on.
You know we be at after party.
Stop holding your tongue, man. Sis.
So hold it.
No, speak
with cut anybody off. What are you talking about?
No, speak of chest. I want to have this conversation with you on a
this is man a, cave.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm about
speak
to get
your
to
shit.
Go.
Pop your shit.
Pass the P.
So go on.
In life.
Life,
apply wisdom and what's the word? In moderation.
Grace.
Because people are like this. People are judgmental. People have these things. So if you are seen as a clink clink girl, A girl, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday motives, people go, she just loves it. And it's vice versa. I think everybody's aware. It's the same way. I think on last week's episode, you said you're aware that with your brand and what you do, a man is, might look at your Instagram and see you in a bikini and just think, like, it definitely just works both ways.
Mm.
But to you, when the actual person doing it, you're like, I'm living my life. I'm not harming anyone. Mm. But then your potential suitor is looking at you like, will this girl calm down?
Yeah.
Or vice versa.
I think that's where I'm at though. Because even my aunt today, she was like, do you know, it's enough now. I said, what's enough? Mm-hmm. She's like, oh, you're older. And you're so down. I said, cool story, bro. That's nice.
Mm.
And she's like, oh, you know, but you're not. She said,
yeah, in the danger zone.
I looked at her and I just thought, excuse me. She said, well, you need to stop acting like a 21-year-old. I said, I don't act like I'm 21.
Mm.
What does a 21-year-old do?
Mm.
Oh, you're always going out. You're always smoking shisha. You're just, yeah. Like, a guy might look at you
it's
and...
the pipe.
A guy might look at you and obviously judge you based on that. And I said, good for him then.
But
like,
I like that actually, though. Because at the end of the day, if you... You're going to age people. What people are doing is aging people to not have fun.
Yeah.
And then you're going to age people, them not to have fun. You pick that said person. And like, why is this person so boring? They don't do nothing.
Fam, hear me out, yeah? So I said this before, yeah? And I feel like not all, some men don't go for their type. There is this stereotype of a woman, yeah? That like culturally, our parents, society has told us is the right person to go for, yeah? Go for a church or a like a religious person, a
prim and proper, keeps herself to herself, Susie Homemaker kind of vibe. Mm. These times, that's not what you're on. You want a freaky deaky bitch who smokes weed, sucks dick, and like twerks while twerking.
I don't know the weed part. But other than that, don't you fuck me with a good time.
No, but do you get what I mean? No.
Yeah, absolutely.
But do you get what I mean? Yeah, hold on. And sometimes, the prim and proper girl that you're after, that's not what she's on.
Boring.
She's not, she's on vanilla sex.
Boring bad.
She's not on going out and having a drink, even just with you, not with her girls, but just letting loose and letting her hair down. That's not what she's on, but that's what you're on. But then you've married her or you've got with her and you're there sitting on the edge of the seat like that fox. You're there just staring like the fox.
Yeah.
And then you're getting threatened with a good time. Yeah. Threatened with a good time by all these other girls who generally your personalities, you vibe with them.
Yeah.
They're on what you're on. Like, they might be a bit too out there. Mm. You know, they might like to have a good time, go out when they're dancing, they're twerking a bit and shaking their ass and having fun though, yeah. Mm-hmm. But you like that fun side because it also allows you to have fun and you have fun together. But no, because you can't, you feel that you can't take her home to mum. Mm. Yeah, or your family or society is gonna look at her a certain type of way. You've gone for prim and proper princess, but you're sitting there like a fox.
Having afternoon tea at the Ritz.
Oh, no. Not even that, but it's like you're just not having. Do you know what I mean?
No,
and then you're seeking enjoyment from either your female friends or like. And I'm saying this because I have male bedrooms that fit that category who are married with prim and proper Susie who will holler at me and be like, "Yo, let's go shisha." Or let's go shisha and put weed in shisha. But these times your missus don't know that that's your vibe.
Smoking weed.
That's your vibe. But that's your bag, right?
Yeah.
But you can't do that with her. She doesn't even know that you do it because she's prim and proper.
Yeah.
So why are you there then?
Yeah, but with the men, it's the whole Sigmund Freud.
Man said Sigmund Freud.
The Madonna whore complex and that. The whore, it represents everything you just said, the ego, the fun side. But there are some men who, for my wife, I'm searching for purity. I'm searching for manageability,
which I get, but then there's no longevity in that.
Because if you're gonna, I get what she's saying. Mm-hmm. If you're gonna, you want that, and you're still gonna be out in the streets,
then you don't really.
But
want
that's
that.
My point, right?
It don't make no
if
sense.
You were happy and not turning your head and not looking elsewhere, and all that and more. And I say this always because as well, like when I've had I had this conversation with men in Ghana because obviously, let's be honest, culturally over there, a lot of them cheat on their wives with younger things. Girls that are out in the club, all of those things, right? Their wives will never go to clubs, but they're happy to, because this is what fulfills them. They're not getting that from their marriage. And that's my point. It's like, for me, marriage is a one-time thing in my eyes, right? You do it once, you do it well, you do it proper. So you're not, I don't see why you're going to go into something that you know doesn't fulfill you fully or tick all your boxes, and you're going to potentially still be moving like an owl, turning your head left and right. And do you know what I mean? Because you're getting the other things that will completely fulfill you from other places, then what's the point?
Because it's like, first of all, how easy is it to get a partner, man or woman, that embodies everything you want and need?
Of course, you're not going to get everything you want and need. But remember, like I said, yeah, I see these things as needs, not wants. Because for me, it's like, do you get what I mean? Like,
yeah, you want to be able to enjoy.
If you want to, like, for me to enjoy your partner is not a want. To me, it's a need. It's a necessity. It's like, it's part of your relation. Wow, should we go have relation? It's part of your relationship. It's like people saying, "Oh, and I used to be this person. Oh, I don't date for looks. I don't have to be attracted to my partner." Bitch, shut up. You do, because when you lot are arguing, and you turn and you look at my man. You know what you don't want to do? You don't want to be like, ew.
I gave you a chance.
Your attitude stinks.
Charity on you,
bitch. Your attitude stinks.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like you as a person. And now I'm staring at you and you're not even cute. Knock it off and get out.
Knock it off.
Do you understand what I mean? So it's like, people will say stuff like, "Oh, I'm not, it's not all about looks." And my mom was even saying it to me today, like, "Oh, but you know, it's not always about looks. And as the beauty, sometimes you have to go for the beast." I literally stared at her and I said,
"Mom said that about who? Him?"
My aunt.
Girls.
No, my aunt said that today about like, "Oh, it's not always about looks and whatnot." And I said, "You're lying, because and yes, it's not always about looks, but it's about attraction, right? I need to be attracted to my partner. So as long as I'm attracted to them, it is what it is. But don't come and make it seem as if like me saying that I want someone that I'm attracted to is being like childish or like it's bigger than that. You know what
down.
I mean?
Yeah.
It's not a want, it's a need.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm trying to say? So that's why I'm saying like there are wants and needs, But you have to be honest about your want and your needs. And if your need is that you need your partner to embody your personality and have, and I guess for everyone, it's not that important. But my thing is, if you think it's not that important for you, but you're in your marriage, relationship or whatever, and you find that you're still searching for this thing outside, then you played yourself, in my opinion.
Now, hey, do you remember the J. Cole skit? Mike Epps, where he says, you see the guy out with his missus.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, oh, how are you doing, fella, today? You all right? And he's like, proper. And he sees the guy again. He's like, so where's the hoes at?
Press
that. Yeah.
That's exactly what he's talking about.
That's what I'm talking about. And I'm pretty sure you probably, let's be honest and let's be out here, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
You guys have friends who I'm sure are in relationships, right? Or marriages. Who you've gone out with and you've seen move mad, and you're thinking, rah, like, not is everything okay at home, but like, you're in a relationship and your relationship seems cool, but they stay out here cheating or they stay out here. Do you get what I mean?
Nah, yeah, I see what you're saying.
Where does that come from?
Yeah. Gluttony, greed.
You be making some.
Why are you chewing like that? do you get what I mean, though?
Some tasty sweets.
I get it.
I be hearing you.
Do what you're doing. Do what you're doing. But yeah,
do you know what I'm saying?
I hear what you're saying, because in reality, as I said, you don't want to be back out here doing the same thing you're doing, because you're not getting, like, I know, like, you might know people that you meet their missus.
Like, how is that your girlfriend?
Like, how?
I know you.
Like, what do you mean you can't come or you can't do this? And you got to say you got to go here, but really you're here because you can't go out.
Long.
Yeah, but that's what I think. It's about literally taking a decision. And I think men look more at manageability, because the quote unquote fun time, I liken it to this analogy, is that at the end of the day, if I'm going on holiday, I know I'm turning up in Vegas, Miami or wherever, but that's only for 2 weeks. When I'm coming home, I'm coming home to shitty routine London, which is better than, I'd rather live a London life than an eternity in Miami. Because it's just,
of course, it's
just
intense.
It's just,
you know, yeah, no, but it, but it's about balance though. Mm-hmm. Because if you're craving just for those moments, and you can't enjoy the sustainability of what you have, eventually it's gonna eat you up.
Yeah.
Like, not now, maybe later on. Cause you might be looking at her like, or she might be looking at her husband, like her partner, like, oh, you be getting my last nerve. And it's like, eventually those, say you go on a boys' trip every year.
Yeah. And that's the only time you get to actually really be yourself.
And then you come back after. Guys, we need to do this.
Back to Susan. Yeah. We need to do this more often.
Wait, yeah. can we do this twice a year? And then it becomes, mm-hmm. You want me to come to your aunt's thing? Nah, I'm going with the guys because I want to, like, that means there's no balance. You're not really, not saying you want, you don't have to be two extremes, but there should be some.
Oh, Yusuff is enjoying himself.
Well, I have seen for a bit.
No, Yusuff, what I heard him say, he says, this is good.
Did you actually say that?
Yeah.
Fucking
bitty,
bro.
And you know what? He didn't come to me. I was watching you chew for a time. You weren't looking.
But yeah, it's just one of those. No, I get you. Because I do feel like it's the same reason why guys, I think it's the same with some women as well. It's like, you're dating men that you don't like.
Mm.
Like, he's just secure.
You don't like who he is. You don't like nothing this about him.
But that's what I'm saying. I think on both sides is, with the time you had, you wasn't able to get somebody that, it's either you wasn't able to get somebody that embodies everything, or you just, not you settled for what you believed you could manage long term.
But it's not, are you managing it, or are you just, I'm going to put my chips in quickly because, like, I'm here, innit?
Mm.
Because did you actually explore? Because sometimes people don't explore. Mm. They like, they might leave the rave at 9. They got
sorry, but yeah.
But that's the thing, because that guy who wants the fun girl or can cheat on his wife for the fun girl, he might have told himself, I can't do 40 years with this. I just need a couple nights with this. So that's might be
but
the problem.
That's where the problem lies for me. Yeah, though, it's because you're, I always see it as when it comes to cheating, yeah,
mm-hmm.
it's not just about you though, innit? It's absolutely. Very selfish. It's not about you. And more often than not, the impact is a lot more for the other person.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, if you can't do 40 years of this, you clearly also can't do 40 years of that. Which is why you're over there. Do you understand what I mean? It's like,
but this 40 years is more manageable than that 40 years.
Then be by yourself.
Maybe some man need to start making that decision.
No, honestly, because I think, because honestly, for me, it's like, it's not worth, or be real.
Mm-hmm.
If you're real.
Do you know what?
Yeah. I was, and you see with me, yeah? Mm-hmm. Like, men say that women don't like the truth, yeah? But hear me out, yeah? It's not about what I like,
mm.
yeah? I would rather you rattle me, mm. shatter my dreams with the truth and honesty, yeah? Mm-hmm. And then I can decide what I want to do with that piece of information. But you've given me the choice.
Do you know what?
Then with that, you make my decision for me by lying to me and allow me to believe a narrative that is not real. Because 7 out of 10 times, the truth is going to come out anyway.
Mm.
So, do you know what I mean? If we're going to end up in shits anyway, you might as well just be honest from the jump. Like, do you know what I mean? Just be honest. But listen, I'm not going to lie. I don't think I can do this monogamy thing, yeah? And I'm going to be honest. Like, this is just me being honest and being truthful with you, innit? Is that something you can handle? If the answer is no, then maybe I'm not the one for you. But remember, there's somebody out there for everybody.
Niggas want to have their cake and eat too, sis.
They do.
You know what? I've heard
some women do.
I've heard a scenario of a man saying to his lady, "I'm gonna need. I need 2 trips a year. I'm gonna go on 2 trips a year. I come back. No questions. No answers.
Mm.
Very simple.
Literally.
And
if you can handle it, by all means.
And that lady, said, "Oh, yeah, cool."
Mm.
If you need time by yourself,
because even listening to Nick Cannon on Joe Budden's podcast today,
yeah,
I don't choose to live my life how he chooses to live his life. But the more I listened to him, the more I understood he's saying exactly what you're saying. Every woman that comes into my life understands what I'm about. I'm about producing kids, growing my village. I'm too busy to be monogamous, so we can have fun. They understand the part of the deal, which is that you will be looked after well. I will treat you with respect, but I just do this multiple times. And it's giving you on a platter and saying, this is my terms and conditions. If you're with it, not. So,
yeah.
And that's why I'm saying, yeah. And you know what? Do you want me to be honest with you? I feel like people aren't having honest conversations, because a lot of the time, yeah, if you are real with people and people are real with themselves, they will agree to that shit. Do you know how many women that if you have and I'm not saying I'm one of them, but I've had conversations with different women who are like, do you know what? Back in the day, they weren't on this polygamy thing. And I'm not saying that they are, but listen, if it's a case of my guy does his thing, I don't know about it, I'm being looked after, whatever, and the bullshit doesn't come back to me.
Out of sight, out
there's,
of mind.
There's loads of women who, if they're honest with themselves, if they were presented with an opportunity like that to a point where it was in their best interest or in their favour, they are going to take it.
The other day, it's about peace.
And guess what type of men make these propositions? Men with money.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Men with money make these propositions to women.
Yeah.
Because they can.
Men without money don't make these propositions because they can't.
They can't.
Make the proposition.
They can't make
a
proposition.
No, but they'll still do
it. A woman will tell me, rich men are cheating.
Yeah, they'll still do it. But they won't proposition you with it.
Yeah,
they'll
still do it.
Yeah. It's part of a...
Yeah.
It's only, I think, the ones that are not rich that they'll do it are only ones because they might be dealing with it and then know that ain't got many options.
Yeah.
So like, I'm the best
you're going to get.
Yeah.
I just think, yeah, if everyone was a lot more honest and straightforward with themselves, I think there'd be less friction between men and women.
But it's all the Western thing, isn't it?
Huh?
It's the Western world ideals that it's like you can't shake.
No, like, and that's
you can take a polygamous thing to a girl that subscribes to Western ideals. It sounds mad. I think there was an episode of you and, I forget her name, Mavinga.
Dana, sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And she said, you was like, I'm not where you're at.
Because obviously, because again, she's very much the continent.
Yeah, yeah.
She embodies the continent, so she gets it. She's even said it. She's already said that in the conversation. She always say this, sister. What are we cooking our husband today? I'll boil the yam and you do. Do you know what I mean? Like, she always says that. She's like, she literally is just like, brother, bro, this is what my ancestors were doing, and it is what it is. I can't come and kill myself because regardless, you're gonna do it anyway.
Do you think women who are happy to be in that situation, they've kind of like removed the emotion from a relationship? 100%.
If you are attached, if you're too touched emotionally, you won't be able to get there. Yeah, I'm too emotionally involved with people. Like, I'm too emotional. That's how I know I couldn't subscribe to that. I'm a jealous hoe as well. Like, I don't want to share. So I know that I'm not, that's what I'm saying. I'm not sitting here talking like this because it's something I know that I can subscribe to. I really can't. But I'm just saying, if people were transparent, I feel like there would be less friction between men and women, especially in our community. Did you see the, have you seen the reels, the joke reels, when it was like, if men and women were honest on the first date, the American thing, but the girl got in the car and then the guy was like, hi, how are you? And then he's like, you look cute. And she's like, yeah, I'm just here for the free food. And he's like, what? We're not going to eat? She goes, no, I'm not going back to mine. She's like, I don't have sex on the first date. He's like, all right, cool. Well, see you later. She's like, all right, cool, bye. And gets out the car. It's jokes.
That's sick.
It's too sick. They've got like a whole where it's like, that's it. Men and women were honest about dating, sisters come in just for free food. You want the coochie. She's like, you're not.
To be fair, we can have that conversation over the phone. We don't even have to be up.
That's what I'm saying. But it's like, she literally got in the car. He drove down the road. The moment she said, he was like, whoop, okay, he's just out. She's like, okay, nice to meet you. Gave him a hug and got out of the car. Yeah. No issues, nothing. Just
I like that.
No, but you,
I like that. I know he got that fucking chingy in it.
Chingy.
I like that.
Right there.
Fucking cute.
But yeah, so it's like, but do you get it? Like, if that's how it was, there'd be no issues.
Are we ready for
I think there'll still be issues, but less, but then it's with our certain conversation people. How can I put it? Certain people are available, are able to have an honest conversation because maybe for who they are, or they're just kind of an upfront person. A lot, some people,
for fear of losing,
some people date with what they can get. So the whole being honest is almost like redundant because they're like, I can't let them, like, you know, some people hide who they really are just to maintain a relationship on both ends, not even just about cheating, I think, just who they really are. I don't want to be like this because I won't get people, blah, blah, blah. So that it may be, ideally that probably work, but it just needs more people to be more.
It's all facades, man.
Reflective with themselves first.
I just think moving forward, like, to me anyway, I'd rather a guy, listen, sis, I want to tear up in your bum. All right, cool. I'm not on you tearing up in my bum. Cool.
So vulgar.
Oh, that's how I... Listen, I T-O-T-B.
So wait, so when...
T-O-T-B-B.
So when a guy approaches you, so you just want to fuck me, right?
Literally. Yeah, I do. All right, cool. I'm not on that. All right, cool. Next.
I'm not going to lie. If a girl said that to me, she's just giving me the opportunity to say yes.
Hey, Rick.
I'm happy you asked. What happened?
No, like, honestly, just be honest and upfront, sis. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not trying to date you, take you out on dates and get to know you. I literally want those cheeks. That's it. Alright, cool. Thank you, I appreciate it. I'm not on that though.
Imagine, don't you think girls want to be sold a dream?
No,
some girls do. I've had the conversation with
some girls.
Honest, I don't want to be sold a dream.
No, I know you don't, but some girls do.
Perhaps.
Why not, like, perhaps?
Because the Disney Channel story that we've been fed.
Oh, fuck Disney. I said this yesterday, stupid bastards.
Channel 613.
Ruined my damn childhood. Yeah. Had me growing up thinking motherfucker gonna come and save me and shit. I'm joking.
You know what? Some women like the beautiful lies.
Yeah,
beautiful.
That's true.
And
really?
Yeah, because they know it's not going nowhere.
Yeah.
But just don't tell me it's not going nowhere.
Yeah, just woo me.
Don't tell me it's not going nowhere.
Yeah.
Take me out, woo me, we'll do the thing and then I'll get over it. I've had this convo with girls.
You know
before.
What's crazy?
We can do this dance.
You know what? I can't. Do you
exactly.
Know what?
Some women are willing to dance with you.
You know what? Do you know
what?
I'm not. I can't.
It's me. Take a little money for me.
You know what? I can't do that, you know. I'm too emotionally invested in people. But, like, I get too emotionally invested. So I can't dance with you. That's why for me, it's just easier if you're up front. Gee, I'm not gonna lie. You see your cheeks? Rotund. Like, you know what? I'm gonna make a booty jiggle, dude.
Rotunda.
Literally, just let me know. Then I can be like, all right, cool.
But you're honest. But the thing is, you're quite, the way you even speak and you're saying that, a lot of people can't.
Jason? I'm seasoned in fuckery. Yeah. I have a PhD in fuckery from men. Legitly, I'm seasoned. So for me, it's like I've dealt with the, I've done the lies, the cheating, I've done it all, and it's just too emotionally draining for me. So for me, I just want transparency from the jump. Like, let me know if it's all, and even if it's gonna hurt my feelings, I'd rather get over it in that moment.
Yeah.
Than catch feelings or like there'd be a lot more strings attached. So it's harder for me to walk away or let go.
You know, the issue is, I think the way guys see you, they don't think that I want to tear open your bum bum line is going to work. So they won't come with that line with you because you don't seem like a girl who's going to go for that.
But I don't want to. So don't.
Exactly.
Don't
hence why they're not going
to
come with that line.
Yeah, a lot of guys ain't going to.
They ain't approach you like that.
They ain't approaching that. The thing is.
So basically, what you're saying is, the thing is, what I want is not going to happen because obviously, regardless of whether they're transparent or not, they want to tear open my bum. Like, that's,
yeah, they do,
that's the
but
goal.
They ain't telling you like the way you want them to tell you.
Because, okay. Yeah.
So they're going to wrap it up in a bow and try and see if they can get away to tear open my bum.
Yeah.
Long term.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Sounds painful.
Hold on, when you say bum, are you talking about the anus hole, or are you talking about just
doggy, man?
Oh, okay.
Like just my cheeks, just cheeks.
Okay,
in your
okay,
hands.
Okay. I thought you were talking about
or that view.
The anus.
No.
I think it's men are not gonna approach you that way. Just because of who you are, how you carry yourself, and because you know the bros them. So that's just not.
Okay, so then just leave. Do you know what it is? Honestly, this is just a PSA. This is a PSA. See with me.
Don't say leave you alone. Don't.
I really am. Legitly. Honestly, if you are gonna come with problems and be problematic, and you don't want peace, just leave me alone. Because honestly, see with me right now, I'm so big on peace. I just want peace of mind. I don't want nothing problematic. I told you I'm seasoned. I'm tired. Do you know what I mean?
Gina, do you know what I think you need to lose your bum.
Maybe
because you automatically just sex, it's like you're scared of being of your sexiness because a guy coming into your life that sexualizes you or finds you attractive or has thought about it's like or it should be a good thing in a way you have to balance it being a good thing but it's hard for
let me be honest, I don't like guys that lead with their dick, and I say this because why did you look at
him? I don't know, but I know it's going to be funny.
But you know what I mean by guys that lead with their dick?
Yeah, exactly.
Yes, no, that's
so
why it's funny.
So for me, it's like, okay, I get it. Rotunda. Rotunda. We get it, yeah. And I hear that. And again, I don't dress to hide it. I don't necessarily show it off, but it's back there. It's there, isn't it? Mm. Do you know what I mean? And I'm not prancing around because I want you to see it. It just is what it is, right? So if I meet a guy and you make it obvious that you're attracted to me, fair enough. And I guess you're only going to approach me if you're attracted to me anyway, right? At first glance. Not because you've heard me speak, but it's what it is. But I think what becomes annoying is like, if like the first initial conversations
is sexual.
Are very sexual.
Mm.
Like, you're sending me like tongue emojis and you know... So
that's, pardon?
No, you know, I'm not going to lie.
What is that?
Or the water. The splash.
Wait, guys are sending that straight away.
It's on my ear.
I
thought I was doing this.
As in some guys, you can tell the conversation is always like... Splash. Do you know what? Even the love struck guys, even the love struck guys sometimes, it's just like...
The yummy time.
It's too much because it's just
I think love struck eyes can be a bit like a little nice innocent.
I don't know, man. Sometimes it's not innocent.
Is it
not like sleazy.
But is it over certain like maybe pictures?
Yeah.
Where, and you're like, knock it off, bozo.
Yeah. Like, so I think it's not a case of me being scared of, don't look at me like that.
You put on your freecom dress, you got sexy, you posted a picture. What do you want them to put? The non emoji.
You put the picture where you were looking back. You stood to the back and you looked back.
Yeah.
So you're saying, look at my bum.
So what, do you want him to comment on your picture? Right?
The dress was backless.
What? You stood that way and looked that way.
The dress was backless.
What does that mean?
It's a backless dress.
Backless
I know what a backless dress is, but that's the point.
Yusuf's point is, I'm like, he's a men. I don't care about no backless dress.
Okay, I care about my backless dress.
No, you care. But
I care about my back.
Oh, what you're telling me is you pose that way to show off the backless dress?
Yes.
Knock it off.
Okay. Knock it off.
No, it's not even a knock-off situation. Do you know why it's not a knock-off situation?
That's a great ensemble.
No, hold on a minute. Hold on a minute. No, it is. Because hold on a minute, yeah. I could easily always pose backwards.
But you wouldn't do that. That's cringe.
Because that's
That's not my point. But so, that picture was.
Because the dress was blacklist. Do you not get my point?
No, I get my point.
It was an outfit of the day. OOTT.
Is that the equivalent of a man them having a jersey on Jordan in the back? So you stand. So 23 nigga balls.
Chicago.
Basically, what I'm saying is, yeah, if I was a girl who consistently posed in that manner, then I would agree with what you're saying about I wanted to show off my bum.
Yeah.
And the point I'm making is no. Because the dress was backless. If I'm wearing a backless dress, nine times out of ten, I'm posing backless.
Hand in hand.
I'm sure.
A little bit. No, I know what you're doing.
No,
it's more of a fashion pick than a booty pick.
Yeah, I don't do booty picks.
Here's my backless dress, but the bum is a bonus, right? Yeah,
that's a bonus.
Take this fashion, but have this ass.
Return.
Bro. The thing is,
you're gonna see it
regardless. Yeah. Like, return is there, isn't it? I can't. What am I gonna do? Let's my cheeks.
No, but if you stood front facing, then
the dress is backless.
I'm not buying this excuse.
Anyway,
You know what? It's twofold though. One, I kind of agree with Syd. Sometimes, lean into who you are. Gina runs away from.
Can I be honest?
Hold on. Explain what leaning into her is.
As in, like, people are gonna find it attractive, in but sometimes I think you shy away from that.
Mm.
Is that?
Does she?
Please, I'm shy.
I'm saying, hella evidence that the contrary to this.
No, she. There's elements of it actually. Please, I'm shy. But just okay. There are some guys that. Are gonna want you because you're Yams FC.
Yams FC.
Okay.
All right, cool.
But there are guys that are attracted to you because they're just attracted to you.
Okay. I've been told, that I'm very awkward. And I hear it because upon seeing me, like you said, you assume I'm a certain type of way. Then when you talk to me, my friends are like, grow up, man.
Mm.
Like, you're actually immature. And it's not even being immature, but it's shy, it's awkwardness. Isn't it?
How do you behave? If a man says a compliment, is it cringe bucket or is it like, thanks?
No, it's never a thanks. Is that okay? No, I'm not. Okay.
Damn.
But it's only, that's a me thing. Like, it's not because I don't rate you or like I'm thinking, but it's just, I don't like compliments like that. Mm-hmm. So it's just like,
I'm a bit the same.
Or my response will be, please, I'm shy.
Mm-hmm.
And then it gets a bit awkward. But so I agree with the whole not leaning into it kind of thing. Or like, I remember when one guy was like, why are you trying so hard to not be the baddie that you are? I said, who told you I'm a baddie? He's like, you're a baddie, but you act really awkward. I was like, yeah, because this is me though. Mm-hmm. Don't be fooled because Rotunda. Literally, that's all. Because you're seeing it and thinking I'm a certain type of way. These times, I'm a neek. A big one, you know?
But that's not a bad thing.
No, of course it's not. And I love how I am and I will never change it for the world.
So, I guess, let's say a guy draws you, you're chatting, it's vibing, and then, I don't know, week two, a little sexual little chat throwing in there.
What's give me an example.
Tell us.
Take me there.
Okay,
take us one from your book.
Your books,
innit? Your playbook.
No, I'm gonna do that. Just it goes like, I don't know. Gina, your shape is crazy. Something light.
That's calm. That's calm.
Mm-hmm.
That's fine. And if we were continuing to, why are you saying? You're annoying, man.
No, because in my head, I feel like you might be like, you just want to grab on me.
No, I'm not going to lie. A lot of the time, though, a lot of the time, do you know what I do? I'll be like, I'll be in my bed just kicking the cover and stuff.
Yeah.
Why? Like, there's guys. No, there's a guy last year that I met, I didn't just meet him, though. Like, I've known him for a while. And I just used to think, why is every conversation about body, bruv. Like,
romance me.
That's what he wants.
I've got, you know what I mean? No, but that's what I'm saying. But so what, guys that leave their dick.
But what a lot of guys don't know is the way to a girl's, it's not, it's through her head. Like,
talk heavy.
You can, a girl tactics. Can fall in love with you just based on this conversation, and vibe. And she's
and she's
gonna want to sleep with you.
Yeah.
You ain't made no sexual innuendos. Facts. No convo, but because of the connection you've made intellectually, she now wants you.
Facts.
She look at you like, this is... Like,
it's, you know, facts.
Lipsy's got a lyric, never talk about the sex, make her want to sex more. And it's facts.
I don't know if you guys might agree. If I know a girl's got a particular feature that is
very prominent,
I never... Yeah. Ever. Like,
Gina's got nice lips, you know. These times I'm trying to grab on. You gotta divert their attention. I know what you're saying, bro.
Because for me, it's like, my head is like, you've been...
That's still sexual though.
But how many people nice have
dick sucking lips?
How many
sorry, no.
Dick
sucking lips.
How many people have already approached this lady?
You gotta think of something different.
Same way, and have you know, like sometimes, even if the conversation and she's gave you the alley hoop, you're like, no, man, that's not for me. Because that's not how we're going to play this. Mm-hmm. But in general.
But I would respect that more and you intrigue me more because clearly you're trying. It might even be game, but if that's the game you're running, no, and you want to score.
No, because it's more the fact that I know you're going to be conscious of it.
Yeah.
Because it's something that people lead with all the time. That's a reality. And if we're having a normal conversation, then you feel like a normal person rather than Yams FC. Like, it's not really necessary.
Do you know what's jokes? There's a rapper, a UK rapper, on my Snap here. Yeah? And it's jokes because every time, like, if I post something, he always comments, turn around. And that's a big man.
Is it Joe Black?
Who's Joe Black? Who's Joe Black, please? Who's Joe Black?
Some random guest.
random.
That's
okay. But he's always...
No, Joe Black's a real rapper.
Yeah, I know. But it's legitimately always on a banter, like...
Sorry, Joe Black, I just threw it in.
All the time, it's like, oh, turn around. I'm like... And I said, what for? And I said, and then when I turned around, what happens next? He said, vibes. I said, you know what?
I like that, bro. You need to piss off.
But he literally, every... Gina, stop it, man. Of course you want to know who it is. Of course you want to know.
Open up notes.
All the time, that's what I do.
The thing is, that's... You could only...
All the time. All the time.
No, it makes sense.
On a regular.
It makes sense.
On a regular basis.
Then, vibes.
Then he said...
I was just about to do an ad-lib. I had to reel it back in.
Yes, please. Really.
Say it under,
So... It's hard.
Just tell him to.
If it's a B in it, is it B?
No.
The one I'm talking about.
Yeah.
What, the lyric?
No, but the ad lib.
Yeah. Look at a C, nigga. Damn.
We're on the same page. You're thinking of maybe
a lyric, but I'm the ad lib.
What he says, the one I'm thinking, makes sense because her initial is in it.
Write it down, please. Write that one.
You don't know that one?
No, because this
is... He says it all the time.
You know this one.
Hold on. This is what we're talking about.
No, the one you're talking about, I know that.
Oh, that one. Oh, okay.
Let me see.
He says that all the time.
Oh, yeah. But we're talking about this, innit?
Absolutely.
Yeah, we're talking about this.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but yes.
Makes sense.
Go ahead. But yeah. But again... Lead him with his dick.
My mouth is really
thick. No, stop it. But again, lead him with his dick, yeah? So it's like, if anything was to ever come from that situation, not that it would, but I'm saying, like, you've made it very clear, like, all our interactions. Mm-hmm. Like, we obviously have normal conversation, but just know when there's a snap or whatever, where it's like going at whatever, it's a turnaround.
Hold on, I swear he's got a missus.
Where? Men in it.
But you know what the thing is, yeah? A lot of fruitful things can come from that. Because, I don't know, at the first hurdle, you've been like, lead him with his dick. Yeah, he can lead with his dick because he just thinks you're paying. But something fruitful can actually come from that. But it's almost like it's filled.
Feature.
You're a joke, man.
Collab.
So,
this is
a collab.
What fruitful things, bro?
But the thing is, I get what you're saying, but it depends on, because if you're leading with your dick and that's prominent in your conversation, like, it's that is hard to deter, like, women already seeing that, okay, this is, then you're moved out of the category. So you might have been in one lane.
Yeah.
And if you consistently hang on a moment, you know, have you had like a moment of a girl, like you're back and forth, it may turn sexual. If you hang on that moment for too long,
yeah,
it's ruined the moment.
Get out of there.
So you got to get out of there.
Well, with him in particular, I don't think he ain't taking it seriously.
No, of course he's not.
It's a slapstick, banter.
Yeah. It's banter. It's consistent.
Because if he was taking it seriously, he wouldn't be just throwing out windows every.
No, of course.
So let's take it with a pinch of salt.
No, I genuinely don't.
No, I know you don't care.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like, if a guy approaches you like that all the time, he's not taking you seriously. He's just,
100%, you know, Brazil. But that's why I'm saying those are the ones where I'm just like, knock it off. Because we both, and you're from my responses, you can tell I'm also not on it.
Yeah, no, he probably knows you're not on it. So he's just doing it for sport.
So let's just cut the graph.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean?
I hear that, yeah. All right, cool. I don't know if you want to take it serious. We've got a couple serious topics to get to. So first, Jamal Edwards' mother, she came out and released a statement, and she gave his cause of death, which was he had a heart attack due to an overdose of recreational drugs.
I don't think it was an overdose, you know. I think he just didn't say overdose, it said use of
of recreational. They didn't say what the drugs were, just that they were recreational. Thoughts.
I'm not gonna lie, I think that's so so unfortunate. So unfortunate, because it's I don't want to say this in a harsh way, but it's self-inflicted, isn't it? Do you know what I mean? And it, where he had so much life, he had so much more purpose. Not more, but obviously God's hands of his time in it. But do you get what I mean? It's like, it's such a sad way for him to go.
Yeah.
Because it was self-inflicted. And it was a wake-up call, to be fair. Not that I partake in like recreational, do you know what I mean? But it's like, you could, or even like the girl that passed away, the black girl, she died not too long ago. I think she took edibles.
Yeah, I'm
single parent. This was like probably like last month. She took edibles. She took edibles in uni, and then had like a really bad reaction. Came home, and she got hospitalized, and she died. And obviously, and that's her mum's only child.
Yeah,
but when they laced,
because I
correct me if I'm wrong,
but
I don't know if she bought them off.
Okay,
a random.
So what I'm saying, what the thing is, when you're on a night out or whatever the vibe is, it's like, oh, I've got edibles, or I've got this, or I've got this,
or
and it's
balloons
like,
is a new
one. And it's like, it seems so innocent in the moment, right?
Mm.
But you generally don't, 9 times out of 10, one, you don't know what is even in these products. You don't know how your body's going to react, and it's scary because you don't know that this is going to be the last. Do you know what I mean? So it is a wake up call to be more mindful.
Of course.
Especially if you're someone who, like, is about that drug life and like it's part of your like your thing, and when you're on a night out, you do this, all that kind of stuff. Yeah. I think you have to be so careful because, mate,
balloons, coke. Mm. I think we can put coke into the recreational category, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Lean
as well.
Yeah,
the pills, Molly. Was it
MDMA?
All that stuff.
Ecstasy.
Those are definitely recreationals.
And obviously, from, I guess, films and like what you hear, whenever there's like a bad, it's always like a bad batch, right?
Yeah.
That were either, like I said, laced with something else or like rat poison, or there's always an extra ingredient that's not generally
fentanyl. You always hear fentanyl.
Yeah, nowadays, that's a big thing.
That's what they said that was in Kevin Samuels' cocaine. So.
Oh, he died from coke?
Yeah,
apparently it was fentanyl.
Oh, I didn't know he was.
What is fentanyl?
Fentanyl's
it's an opioid.
It's an opioid, but it's one of the strongest opioids that exist ever.
And
it shouldn't be. Basically, it was used, they was testing it out, and then it somehow got on the street, and they started mixing it with heroin. And so it's like a cutting agent. And then basically, the dosage, it can be really micro. And that can affect a big batch of whatever drug it is.
Mm-hmm.
And people may be able to take it once, twice, about a couple of times and be fine. And then to start just like that.
Really?
Yeah, it's a really
drugs are scary.
Yeah. In certain city, certain states in America, they have an actual say pandemic, but with
it's an issue.
Yeah, it's a massive issue, and now because some people have realized how addictive it is, and they just know that people want, they're like, okay,
it'll be better for them business wise.
Business wise, right? They don't mind cutting corners.
What's the other one? Snus or something.
Snus, yeah, that's like a tea bag you put underneath your
gums.
Your gums, or, yeah.
You know what's weird is that some people, even back in the day, some people used to play football with it.
Yeah, I heard about footballers.
Why?
Play football. Oh, you mean use it to play football?
Yeah.
Oh.
Why?
Because basically it
makes basically relax.
Yeah, basically, but when you breathe it, it helps with your I can't remember what the benefits were, but even when I play Saturday football, sometimes you see like you guys have it, you'd be like,
snus.
Do you know what it is about drugs and all that stuff, I don't like not being in control of how I feel.
Yeah.
And it's not like and generally speaking, a lot of these things, even with alcohol, they don't wear off. It's not like, okay, I'm having fun now and then you know when you get to a point where you're like, okay, I want to go back to normal now because I'm over it. Yeah. It never works like that, right?
Mm.
I hate that feeling. I hate the feeling of like...
being out of control.
Being out of control. And I'm quite an emotional person. So I always feel like my emotions are extremely heightened like when I'm in that space, which is what I don't like. So I'd rather just, and the aftermath, I hate the next day, the being tired, the lagging, it's so annoying. Yeah. So those are the reasons why I don't particularly like partake in stuff because it's jarring. It's just, all the extras are just like, oh. If it was a thing where you take it and then, or you can have, maybe that's why I like shisha because shisha don't make me high, but you know, like I find it relaxing.
Yeah.
You can even get lightheaded and feel, do you know what I mean? Mm. But after that, you're all right. Mm. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Maybe that's why that's my thing, because it's temporary.
Because you already know, also because you know how the variables.
Yeah.
I think through alcohols, like edibles, the ones I've partaken in, I enjoy.
Mm.
Brownies are just a no for me.
Yeah, I'm about the
brownies are...
they're too intense, man. No matter the size. I've had a corner. I've had, you know when you... I've tried to try and gauge it in sample sizes. No. I had a whole one, which my friend was like, never have a whole one. Are you mad?
Ever.
I had a whole one and a half.
Huh?
On my birthday. My birthday 2 years ago. I need you to understand, yeah. I don't think you understand the level of embarrassment the next day, because,
But we don't make me act a fool.
No,
it just makes me very just high and chill.
No, and the emotions. No, but that's why I don't know what it was. To be fair, I was drinking. It's my birthday, so I was drinking as well. So maybe
that's the balance, right?
It was bad because I was one extreme to the other. I was laughing, happy, really happy.
Yeah.
Then I went depressed, paranoid. I was crying my eyes out. I was scared to sleep. Scared to bath. I thought if I sleep, I'm going to die. I couldn't go to bed. I was like, if I close my eyes, I'm not going to wake. I was paranoid. Like, it was ridiculous. And then it got to a point where I was like, I'm over this. I need it to stop. Like, this, it has, I can't. And I was like, how do people do this on a regular? Like,
If that an edible, you're supposed to eat sweet stuff to bring it down.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You're not supposed to like have sweet stuff. It brings it down. Funny, so when I went to Amsterdam one time, I went to my friend's
coffee shop.
That was like a stag thing, whatever. Mm. It was like, oh, found some edibles. We spoke to this guy, talked to us through. So like, I just want to laugh. I just want to. Now, we all took it. I was on the phone, calm, outside. I came inside.
Space.
I was like, oh, shoot.
Whoosh.
Hit me. And one of the guys I was with, he's like, Yusuff, like, I was like, yo, come. He started moonwalking backwards. He's a big guy.
It looked like the grieving gorilla.
And I was like, what's going on here? And even recently, my friend came from Portland. She said, to an edible. I'm like, oh, why not? Cool. As I was talking, about, I don't know, an hour later, it hit me. I was like, oh. And we was all laughing and joking, but then I got conscious, like, are they laughing because what I'm saying is funny?
Or are they laughing at me?
Are they laughing at me? Then I had to get to my friend's house. That was the day boxing was on. I was like, I need to gain composure to get to my friend's house. But even when I came down, it is weird. When I finished, when I come down, I was actually cool in a sense of, oh, I'm glad I didn't. Because when I got to my friend's house, like, oh, do you want a drink? I said, no, I'm cool.
Mm.
And I prefer that than when you drink and you feel like, oh, the next day you feel sluggish.
Yeah.
Feel,
I actually don't.
I actually realize that now, drinking sometimes, I was like, I don't want to drink because I don't want that next day of, like, I'm going to miss a day. But in general, I think people, back to the whole point of, people need to be careful of who you're
buying stuff off.
Who you're buying stuff off.
Yeah.
And who you're asking, let me have
and who
some.
You're asking, that's where it comes.
Just part of you being a drink up or whatever, somebody's doing it. You have no, that person don't know where they go. They just go off the corner or whatnot. And then you're just, well, everybody's doing it. Let me sniff. Let me do this. And you don't know the effects. And then in the morning, you could be having a mare.
Yeah, no clue. And you don't know how, obviously, everyone's got families and how it affects your family. You don't think outside of ourselves in those moments, so it's probably something to even think about. Even just think about DMX, how he ended up being on the crack.
Yeah, he got given at a young age, right?
Yeah, but basically someone laced a blunt
when he was young, innit?
Yeah.
And that's,
he got
addicted.
That's so sad.
Papa
getting hooked that early as well. He got hooked young.
Papa, I would have.
Papa young. Because with crack, you're always chasing that high, isn't
it? Yeah, and it's a continuous...
Yeah, continuous chase for life. Because you never get that high again, but you're just always trying to seek it.
And with crack, it's probably the most degrading, but like, you know how, like, for example, weed is not... It's not that much of a degrading drug in terms of, like, what it does to you as your physical appearance.
Mm.
But when you look at crackheads and heroin addicts, like, it literally transforms your whole
being.
Yeah. It's mad.
Yeah.
It's actually crazy because it's just off one...
Yeah, one hit.
Really? So do most people get addicted after, like... They just take it once and that's it.
Because that basically it was... I kind of watch a lot of these kind of documentaries. But with crack, in terms of it's a sensor in your brain that just
opens up.
And as you said, you're trying to catch that
same high.
So you want to go back and, you know, like in Snowfall, when they go.
Wanda.
Yes. No, when,
the police thing. Yes, daughter. Yeah.
How they depicted that is how.
What happened to her?
Yeah. They say that happens to people where they're like, so it'll go back again.
But that's, do you know when I was even talking about it, she's who I had in mind. I just thought it literally was like a one-time hit and then she just literally became, but I think Wanda's one was even worse.
It sounds, what I'm about to say sounds very stupid, but I would not.
You want to try it?
I want to try it because I just want to be like, big man, you can say no. I want to be someone to be an experiment, like, this addiction thing is in the brain. I don't want to, you know, reduce anybody's experience, but allow it, man.
I don't think every single person in the world would try crack and be addicted to it.
And also people, remember, it depends on your personality. I have an addictive personality. Yeah. I know that I do, which is why I don't partake in certain things. See me, if I find food that I like, or if I taste something, I like it, I'm going to eat that food every day until I get sick of it. Like, that's what I'm like.
I'm the same as you.
I have an addictive personality. So I generally don't allow myself to even dabble in certain things on a consistent basis or like, do you get what I mean? Or allow myself because I know it's long because that's my personality. Mm.
But also you obviously know what's good for you and what's not.
Yeah.
So I think even with me, even though I have an addictive personality, I know what's right and wrong. So
yeah.
I'm not going to allow myself to be addicted to drugs because I know it's not doing me any good. It's doing me harm.
But yeah, yes and no, because in certain clips, situations, people have gone to that thing because they may have just had a moment in their life. That's a low point as humans, and somebody put them in that scenario of, I mean, you're in a low moment. I just take this, it'll help you feel better, or blah. And they didn't feel better, and then they just went down that spiral. It's a weird, weird thing.
I think I feel like if you start it from like a, when you're in a bad space, I guess you're more likely going to go down that rabbit hole because it's going to be a thing to always try and make you feel better when you're in that bad space, as opposed to it being like, oh, I'm on a night out and it's a random, you know what I mean?
Mm.
So, yeah.
And that feeling must be mad. Even imagine you someone did that on a night out, went back to their home, didn't know what they'd done, got up, this feeling like, and they were just, didn't know how to,
it's crazy.
That. And then, as you said, it changes your whole being.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right. We're going to talk about hypo.
Can I just say my mom needs to get off Instagram and all platforms of social media? Because the fact that she said to me, oh, okay, did you hear about that rapper that they stabbed in Hackney, Hypo? I said, you need
Auntie's 16.
She needs to reduce. Because you're going to hear this. I said, why does my mom stay in young folk business?
Yeah, so Hypo, East London rapper, part of the Mashtown collective, was fatally stabbed a couple of days ago at a party. Very sad. It's very shocking. Mm. Very shocking. It was I've heard kind of accounts of what happened.
Mm.
And yeah, man, it's very sad, man.
Obviously, just yeah, rest in peace and
yeah, rest in peace.
Like condolences to everybody that knew him, because I know it's affected a lot of people.
Yeah.
And
I thought of Mark straight away.
How's he holding
literally
up?
Literally. He's not good.
Did he record today?
He hasn't recorded for time.
I don't blame him. Like, yeah.
I can imagine. Death is...
That's his guy. That's his code, his right hand. You know what I'm trying to say?
Oh, really? Like...
Yeah, that's...
Yeah.
Hypo and Mark. That's it.
Yeah,
that was tough.
That's a lot, man.
Yeah.
Being from Hackney as well, I've seen... Literally, like, and people might not know or people might troll, but like, on ends, Mashtown music, rap music, some of the freestyles, very, very legendary. So when my group chat heard it, did you say no? They put it in my group chat, then I said it, sent it to you, man. And I was like, impossible. Because it's like, I don't know. Let's say MMG or whatever, and you just wake up one day and you hear Rosé's dead. It's like the main, like, figurehead, like, well-known, well-renowned. It's like, allow it, man. Impossible. It's almost as if he can't die. That don't make no sense.
Yeah.
Who would try him sort of thing? Because it's long sort of thing. Mm. So it's like, to hear that one, I was like, nah. Then, like you said, I thought Margs, I thought, what's it called? And then... So even I thought Askel's gonna hear this in Bing,
which is even
worse, and it was garbage too.
Yeah.
Do you know what it is for me? It's like I feel like we've got to an age where that stuff doesn't happen as often anymore, or maybe it's because it's in the younger circles. It doesn't really affect us anymore. Like when we were younger, I remember like 2016. Like, do you remember there was a period where it was like. People were just, it was too much. And like, I remember the newspaper, I think it was in the Metro, and on the front, there was a year like where they put everyone's picture of who'd like passed away in the year, and they were all black or ethnic. And it was like a epidemic. And then we've kind of moved away from that, it doesn't happen as often.
Yeah.
So I felt like this, it was a shock because one, it's a stabbing.
Mm.
So like we've heard of people passing recently, but I guess their causes are different. So to hear that and that it being a stabbing and stuff like that, it's just like this stuff's still going. Not like it's not that I expected it not to still be going on, but do you know what I mean? It was more like a wow, like
a period of growth. Like I think it comes like because we're older now, and then the period of growth that we've had, it comes a shock to the system. It's like, wow, people still do that, or
literally, or that was it for me because, and especially because I know he's older,
I was even having a conversation, like, I was like, oh, but don't, like, if he's older, doesn't, I said, yeah, but sometimes people that you may have, that person may have grown, but the other person that they're in a situation with
hasn't
grown,
yeah, of course,
and they're not caring about what the scenario is, this is how we deal with things, etc., and it's really sad because I feel like we're just hearing a lot of death, like, and it's so sad to just be around, like, peers, people, like, around your age, or, and you just feel like someone's life, someone that's got engaged not too long ago.
Yeah, I heard
like,
it. And when I heard that, I think what also broke me, because I was like, I don't know what this is, I don't know what she's going through. I couldn't imagine it, but it's like, you've just had one of the most happiest moments of your life happen to you recently. And this is the complete opposite. And it's attached to that same thing. So, not where do you go from here, but I can only, I was like, nah, I don't even know who she is, but she's in my prayers because I can't, oh, completely forgot you were here. I can't imagine.
Wow, that was rude.
No, I forgot what you said. How is that rude?
Move, take a seat.
Like, sorry. But yeah, so it's proper unfortunate, man. But may soul rest in peace.
Yeah, may soul rest in peace, man.
There we go. We're gonna lie in the mood.
It's kind of awkward in here still.
We're gonna lie in the mood because I feel like, oh yeah, rest in peace, Hypo, man. Because that's and everyone that knows him, man.
Yeah, definitely. Right. Well, you guys gonna just keep looking at us, or you gonna sit down? You gonna join in?
Oh, you still
there? Yeah, let me move over.
Am I not in the way of the?
You're not gonna be on camera.
A handsome man entered the building.
Appreciate it.
We got something to lighten the mood on.
No, I'm dead. Why are you sitting like that?
Like, yeah.
You're a boy.
You creeped in the room.
I hope mama don't see me.
No, I'm done. Thank you, because
I apologize.
You know what you look like there?
He
looked like, you know, like when a sex scene comes on and you're sitting with your parents back in the day. Wow. You're like,
awkward. Literally.
I just need to hide.
Can't lie, my body's in pain. That was a long gym day yesterday.
Oh, I was going to say, what are you Brent doing?
What you been working on?
My body's in pain. Brent's open up that bum, bro.
Wait, wow. Why am I the bottom? Why do I got to be the bottom?
No, you're sick.
So were you prepping the top?
This guy.
Wow. I'm asking.
You're a top man?
You're a top man. No, but hold on.
Is this how you roll in the man cave?
Wait,
yeah.
Don't switch places, though.
Brother, I'm not talking about this. I like
women. No, but if you're the bottom. Look, if you're the bottom, that means you're receiving. Wouldn't you now want to receive afterwards? No, why are you laughing?
Were you saying you got yours?
So I got that.
No? No, but isn't that?
I don't know the dynamics.
If someone was given,
yeah,
he's bust his nut. Now the other person wants to bust their nut. So you got to swap over. No?
I'm sure that's kind of
that makes perfect sense.
Perhaps, but you know, some people get off in different ways.
You know what?
No, to be honest,
I don't think that's the case. No, do you know why?
Some people are dominant. Yeah,
let me not.
Otherwise, where would the terms top and bottom come from? Otherwise, if not for there being people that only prefer one,
so there's some guys who are just the bottom.
Apparently,
they don't bust nuts from.
You're talking to me as if I'm the foremost authority on this.
Do you know why I say this? Yeah, because.
It's
really the man cave now.
No, I feel like, no, because I don't want to talk on experiences
something that we don't,
that
really
I don't know about.
No, but obviously they do say that the man's G-spot's in his bum anyway. So that so the bottom guy, he may get off the G-spot sensation.
You know what? I don't want to talk about things I don't.
No, I don't know this. But
I was watching a show on MTV, right? And there was this guy, a gay guy on the show, and he said something like. He was sitting there. He's like, listen, if we're going to get onto the topic, yes, men have, this is what he said.
Yeah.
Yes, men have a G-spot. It's in your rectum. And for $5 and 20 minutes, I can show you. And he was just like, oh, maybe he didn't say $5, but he said something along those lines.
I was intimidated. I'm sure I saw two. Stay away from me.
No, the thing is, exactly what was whipped you like.
Yeah, no, like, I'll show you.
You're sick.
My days.
But yeah. All right. Did you see that's a Safari video with Ray J and Princess?
He's screaming.
Where he's screaming and they're kissing and dancing.
Yeah. I thought Ray J and Princess were.
They
were
get on my nerves, man.
I thought so as well.
Do you know why they get on my
always
nerves?
Back because it's
too dramatic. Like, there's nothing wrong with making up and breaking up and having privately, but it's just he or her, they. One of them always goes to the internet. Like, we don't need to, do you know what I mean? Like, if you lot are doing your thing, just do your thing. Huh?
It's not many princesses that goes to the internet.
Like, you don't need, it doesn't need to be public knowledge, especially where you clearly are both in a situation where the love is there. We hear that, right? And that's clearly why you're still back and forth. But you haven't decided or made that decision as to whether this is what it needs to work for you. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, and I haven't actually worked on, like, the love may be there. But they haven't worked on the issues that causes them.
So it's back and forth.
Yeah,
still going. Do you know what I mean? Thing. So it's like, if that's the case, that's fine. And like I said, no one's relationship is perfect. But when you start making it public that we've broken up and this person's trash, you start going for each other on the internet because you're both childish, The next minute we see you back together. That was like Erica Mena and Safari. They kept going back and forth, but now they're officially divorced. Yeah. We could have saved all of this having a second child and, you know what I mean? To end up where? In the same...
Yeah, I'm just thinking about, when I think about Erica, I'm like, Ross, Safari, like, really?
What, as in you're surprised she chose Safari? Or
no, she likes...
That he went there.
No, but she likes Corny Brothers anyway.
Oof. Hold on. No, but Erica Mendes is not the pick of the bunch.
No, but she was before. When she first brought up in the scene.
She ain't been there for a while.
Huh? Chris Brown, your video.
She ain't been, Chris, huh? She ain't been, like... I'm saying
not for said, a while. For,
what I'm saying is he's making it seem like, oh, how could Erica go with Samara because he's corny? I'm saying Erica Manor to me is not.
And that's what I'm saying. And he said, but she was before. And I said, before was a very long
time. Yeah, no. I'm in my head, I'm thinking about before.
Oh.
Yeah, but then I looked at her roster and it's Corny Brothers after Corny Brothers.
I don't even think it's, do you know what I think it is with her? I don't even think it's her roster. It's her as a person. Like she, and because we see her in her truest form on all these reality TV shows, we see, like, no one can come and tell me that's not who you are. And it's not just for TV.
Yeah.
Since you are very explosive and you have a lot of trauma and a lot of work you need to kind of work through, right?
Mm.
And we see it.
Raul and the brothers there.
And it shows in how you have, how you communicate, your relationship with people, et cetera, right? So, yeah.
Do you think because she's been like, because she is pretty.
I was going to say it's based on pretty privilege.
Yeah, she was fine before.
Mm.
And she had the Raul.
Mm. Yeah.
She didn't need to work at any issues ever.
She does benefit from pretty privilege. Yeah. Because she's pretty. I would never sit here and say that she's not attractive.
She knows pretty, and she knows the shooters.
Well, her personality makes her unattractive to me.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it does. But
that's what I'm saying. She's very expensive.
She's never had to work on her personality because she is pretty and she knows the shooters. So the problem is never her. It says, and she can replace you. There's a bag of man chasing you all the time.
Mm.
She's never, ever in her life going to think, it's me, the problem. No, it's them. Mm. And if they get out of line, you know what I can do? It's very simple. That's, some people have that. Same with men. Some men are extremely handsome. They'll never, ever work on themselves because
they don't need to.
They don't need to.
They've always had girls who've been able to accept them for who they are.
Yeah, until it's enough, and then you move on.
And then move on to the next person.
Yeah. Your Ghanaian brother Thomas Partey, he changed his name to Yakubu because he married his Muslim girlfriend.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, so
for real.
Now he's Yakubu Partey.
Wait. Is that not the same babes that was in the Jeep with?
I'm not gonna lie. That picture, that video, was it a picture or video?
It's a video.
It looked garbage to me.
Yeah, it was very garbage.
I can't remember.
No, it was. She was giving
forcing it vibes.
Do you know the narrative that footballers date white women or whatever? When I saw it, I thought, and it looked kind of... plastic, isn't it? The whole scenario.
Is she black?
She's Muslim, so I'm assuming she's not white,
mm-hmm.
as in British. That's her, but it's not a great picture.
She might be Persian.
So she might be like, maybe Turkish, Iranian, whatever.
So Persia.
Persia hasn't existed for hundreds of years.
Well, Persia used to be Iranian. It's not Iranian now,
sorry,
right?
I don't even know Yakubu. Oh, it is.
But this is, we're giving everyone history.
Mm. Yakubu, as in Jacob.
Yeah.
But it may be just a. So he's giving up
That's a Muslim name?
Yeah. The daytime parties.
Why did you come
here? Oh, it's linked to your thing. I wanted to hear what he was saying.
There's a lot of names that are like in the Bible or deemed Christian names that there's a Islamic version.
Yeah, tons. Like, my name's Joseph.
Yeah.
Moses is Musa.
Yeah.
Jesus is Issa.
Issa, yeah. All right, what else?
Abraham. List goes on.
What else has happened in the world that we can discuss before we leave?
We spoke about Queen's Jubilee.
Oh yeah, well, what's everyone's Queen's Jubilee say? Did you have a white? You had the flag on your car, didn't it?
Don't do that.
You didn't have a flag anywhere.
What if you did? You had two in the back, two in the front, like a limousine.
We celebrate the Queen's Jubilee.
I saw a black guy with the flag.
Was?
So it was at a traffic light. He was like, "Hey, I was here." I looked. That's a black guy. So I pulled up closer just so I could look in. I was like, right, really had a not even the St. George's Cross Union Jack.
He sent me some silly Ghanaian lady.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to look. Play it,
Ghanaians are so annoying, man.
What's his name? Grace. Auntie Grace. She's wearing the full
British dress. It's just the story. And I thought, you guys, you're so performative.
Yeah. Grace, you stood out from the crowd. You look amazing. What was it like here?
Oh, it's nice. Just really nice. The atmosphere is nice. Really, really
She's so
and
good
today
here.
Too. I couldn't get time to come earlier because we had a party on my road and I was so busy. Even I decided not to come. And my husband said, are you going or not? I said, wait, okay, can you drop me at the train station? And I came.
Give me best man.
Yeah, I am now.
What is it about Queen for you guys?
She's beautiful. She's nice. She has worked hard for both Britain and Commonwealth, which I come from Ghana. I'm part of Commonwealth.
Auntie Grace, I come from Ghana, so I'm part of Commonwealth.
To work as long as she can work. So.
And how special was it knowing that she was there on the balcony today?
Was she here? I was late. Thank you, Mom. Coming back. Sorry, my voice.
So much cheering.
Yeah.
Well, the good news is you didn't need that umbrella.
Because I heard it's going to rain later. So I brought it. Anyway, it's the same as my dresses.
No, she's so... Okay. Oh, Auntie Grace here is... It's Ghanaian. She even says she's from Ghana, it's like, here is fam. That's my Aunt Grace, bruv. Like,
she came. That's my man.
You know what? She said what? The story you put on Twitter about chasing.
Oh God,
what's that?
Now, a girl I know posted a tweet. She said something like, "When guys say that women want to be chased." Like, what do they mean? Like, can you give me examples of women saying that? And I said, I don't know. The first time she posted on Twitter, me and some other guy were like, nah, we're not going to tell you. We don't want to play this game. And she's like, what? So I'm like, forget it. The next morning, I see she's still talking about it. So I was like, all right, cool, I'll give you an example. And I said how, when I was like 24, talking to this like, she was like 28-year-old woman, and she said, whenever a guy asks her out, the first time he asks her out, she says she's busy. As a rule. And then she goes, if he really likes me, he'll ask me again. Yeah. Because if I say yes the first time, I'm seeming too desperate. Now, even though I was 4 years younger than her, I still question it. Like, hold on. You like the guy. Yeah. You're interested in the guy. Yeah. You want to go on a date with him. Yeah. But when he asks you out, you say no. Yeah. Because like, that's what you're supposed to do. I was like, huh? So then I put that to this girl on Twitter. And she was like, oh, well, you must just be... approaching wayward girls. I'm like, oh, of course you're going to say that. Like, you asked me for examples. I gave you one. Me, I and any other man who's dated women will tell you examples similar to that kind of behavior. So it's not just, oh, wayward women. It's just, you know, like, even if you don't exhibit that specific behavior, you've probably done something that's similar to that in some way because you feel like, oh, I need to test the guy or see if the guy truly is going to put effort in. It's like, that's not the way to go about it, really. All you're doing is adding unnecessary passer to the situation.
I don't think that's passer per se, because as men, we don't even know this is happening.
I know.
So you know if a girl tells you she's busy, you know it's a lie.
I've spoken to you about a situation where something like
did you catch her in a lie?
Not necessarily catch her in a lie, but I could tell from what she said where she was going with it. Can I tell this story? I've definitely told you.
Okay, but has there been times when the girl told you, oh, I'm busy this weekend. Have you thought, oh, you're lying? You just thought, okay, you're busy.
Not busy, but I think what I get what he's saying, and I'm like, maybe it's almost like they want you to work harder.
No, I get the premise. What I'm saying is, from the outside looking in, how do I know this is a game? Or you're genuinely busy.
But that in that specific situation, you might not know she's busy. Yeah. But there's loads of examples of women like doing stuff just to see if you can do it. Go along with
it. Yeah, of course. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And this girl on Twitter didn't believe that. She was sort of like, oh yeah, only a way would go at that.
Actually, I saw something. I can't remember. I don't know if I sent it to Syd. But basically, it's something where a lady was saying, oh, the test. She was saying, oh, like, after she goes, I test if they're able to, if they've got me. So whether it's not on the first date, so after 2-3 dates, she'll act a bit distant and say, oh, what's wrong? I got these bills coming up and Hey. I don't know what I'm going to do.
I've had that before. Pain.
Or she said, oh, I'm... And I was like, she was like, it's a test to see if that person's got you. I was like,
I really wish a girl would do that to me. A girl has them, but I really wish a girl would do that to me.
I really wish a bitch would.
I'm like, good luck.
It has happened to me. It happened to my boy, though.
Yeah. Like, I got these bills.
My boy used to...
Swear.
God damn, girl.
My boy had a shot cost with living gone up. The Great Britain rowing team, right? So he had to train with them every single day, 6 a.m. down at whatever river they were rowing at, Train for like 2-3 hours in the morning. But he was dedicated, isn't it?
Yeah.
So he'd set his alarm for like 5:30 in the morning, right? So this girl must come around to his yard. The first time she came around to his yard, she had a full bag worth of laundry.
Yeah.
Comes around, he's like, all right, cool, wash your clothes, whatever. And then she stayed at his for like 2 days.
Yeah.
He was like, well, he didn't care because he was beaten, innit?
Yeah.
He was like, all right, whatever. It's Monday morning, I got to get up for rowing. Yeah. So I'm going to get some sleep. She's like, all right, cool, whatever. So he falls asleep now. Bear in mind, he's supposed to wake up at 5:30. He wakes up and it's like 9 o'clock. And he's like, oh my God, I'm going to be late. I'm already late. I've already missed the first training session.
You're done, bro.
Fam. So he's like, oh my God. Blah, blah. And he's getting up and she's like, oh, just come back to bed. And he's like, what do you mean? I need to go training. This is Great Britain. This is the Olympics potentially.
Yeah.
And she's like, oh, is that what you had to do? And he's like, what do you mean? I set my alarm. And she goes, oh yeah, it came on, but I turned it off. She was like, I just wanted to, like, surely you want to come stay in bed with me? He was like, are you like, bear about, this guy's a big guy, yeah. Very angry guy, but he was just trying to be nice to her. The way he described it to me, I was like, oh boy,
my mouth was open the whole time the story.
from the laundry bag.
Why is she bringing laundry bags to wash her clothes?
The girl was bummy.
No, but if you book, now, can you imagine you open your door.
Ghana was back.
And what? There was no prior arrangement.
Yeah.
Like, oh, by the way, I'm bringing some clothes over. Can I wash them at yours? Or she just...
No. He'd been to her place a couple times.
Yeah.
It was the first time she was coming to his.
Yeah.
First time.
And so, So that wasn't even the last thing that happened. She turned off his thing. Yeah. That's his had alarm. Him pissed, but he was like, I need to go to training. So he wasn't even thinking about it.
Yeah.
He ducked to training. She stayed in his yard while he was at training. He come back later and he was like, okay, you need to go now.
Yeah.
And then that's when she decided to explain, oh yeah, I'm in trouble with my apartment. I'm actually like kind of behind on rent. Do you think you could help me out? But I laughed at him because I was like, this is your fault, you know. Yeah. Because he used to just go around and just show off the fact that he had like that he was like a GB rower. So he'd make it seem like he was a celebrity. He would use it to get into clubs and stuff. It worked. Fair play to him. But that's how he got girls. And it's I'm a GB rower. Probably gonna go to the Olympics. So she had him on this high pedestal thinking he could take care of everything.
Yeah.
And he paid the price, boy.
You know my little Jamaican boyfriend?
Yeah.
The one I read you that... Not white briefs.
Padman.
Rinse off.
Not rinse off. The other one. The one that sent me the essay and I said he said he's 27. I showed you.
Yeah.
So this is just off the back of what you said, yeah. So... last week, I got 2 messages, yeah? So we're like, hi, you're right. I'm fine, thank you. How are you? He'll be like, hi, you're right. How are you? I'll be like, I'm good, thank you. How are you? I'm not good. Why, what's up? I'm broke.
Did he spell it with an A?
I'm broke. There's no work. I said, oh, okay.
Yeah.
So you're back in London, man.
He knows back in London. I was like, oh, what do you do for work? He said, oh, I'm a driver. I said, okay, so how is there no work? Because there's hella tourists up in your country and y'all niggas be charging $300 a day. So how's no work? He's like, oh, it's very competitive. Like there's so many drivers out here. I said, oh, okay, that's rather unfortunate. Couple of days later, hello, hi. You're right. I'm good. How are you? I'm not good. What's up? Oh, my car's not working and I need to get new clothes. I said, that's rather unfortunate.
How are you even attending this conversation?
I said, no, because if I find it, do you know why I find it?
I might do it still.
You know what? Because I find it funny. Oh. Yeah, because I'm like, nigga, I'm trying to be somebody's sugar baby and you want to be mad? Boy, but like, you is not using me to send you money to fix your stuff. Are you all right?
Money
like,
brand.
Make it make sense. Like, you and I both know you're not getting a peswa. You're not getting a cupra. You're not getting a dime from me. So I just, like, when he messages me, I never respond straight away. I'll give it like a day or two. And I'm like, oh, you're right. Or then I get a message on Instagram. I'm like, wow, you really chasing me down, huh?
I won't go to details, but that reminds me of a time that me and Tolu went to DR. Yeah. We met with a woman. And after a few days of knowing us, she sent us both a message asking us for money for her salon to help fund her business.
Was she American? Was she from DR?
She's from DR.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, she was actually Dominican.
Yeah.
So she was like, Juso.
She sent us like a
No, that's why I asked, because I'm just trying to imagine, like,
I highly doubt she knew my name, but she
would have said hola papi.
She asked us for money.
Did you
not
give it to her?
What type of person is that?
I know you wouldn't. You'd
give her money. Impossible.
Money you wouldn't, but your friend.
Oh boy.
Duke. Yeah.
You know he a bit. Duke. You know he a bit. He a bit. Hmm.
But yeah.
Oh, God damn it. Nah, Yusuff is killing me.
How are you turning into a joke on me, bro?
Yusuff. He said a CH in it.
She didn't know my name.
Yusuff.
All right. I gotta be here early tomorrow, guys.
Laundry bags, though. Mad.
So that's songs of the week.
I'm seeing him next week as well.
Oh, yeah, I gotta get your videos before you leave as well.
That is.
All right. Songs of the week. Just state your song, please. And then we can.
We don't play no more.
No, copyright infringement. Okay. I'm gonna go with Vory. What's the song I like? The one that you had in your Dark Clouds.
Okay.
Yeah, so yeah. Vory, Dark Clouds, that's off his Lost Souls album.
That's me. That's the new one, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'm gonna take us back to Clipse.
Okay.
I'm not you. I'm not you.
Yeah. Sick. Woof.
I've actually got a Mapiano song. Shout out to Gina.
Come on.
It's called Umlando.
Hey, don't make me stand up and do the dance. Don't make me stand up and do the dance with you. It's the dance. You know the dance where you see people doing the...
Oh, yeah.
Heard that the other day.
Also, Malice has got the best verse in that song.
Yes.
Malice normally had the best verses.
You know what's mad?
Styles P and Jadakiss on that song.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but you know what's so funny about that? Someone was like, oh, how do we know that Malice was the best? Was the best out of the two? That one. I was like, did you not listen to the Clips?
I don't think Malice is the best. I prefer Pusha T.
Like both, but there was times that Malice showed there was...
No, Malice is good, but I always prefer Pusha T.
You know what it is? It's almost like, I reckon Malice can ride a beat better, but Pusha can have like just really hard bars that you'd be thinking about for time.
And I really prefer Pusha's voice to Malice's voice.
Okay.
My song of the week is called Soweto by Victony and Tempoe.
Also, everyone send me the songs, please.
Yeah, I'm doing it now.
KO Beats London.
I'm gonna go with Mashtown Stand Up.
Them ones.
I hear that.
R.I.P. All right, cool. All right, guys, this has been Man Cave episode 8 featuring Just Jean and a nice little cameo. Mammoth.
Yeah.
Peace. We will see you next week.
Peace.